he sticks it. Garrison Matthews has checked in for Atlanta. 6-point lead for the Hawks. Malachi to the basket, lays it up, lays it in. James Wiseman on the rush. Jalen Duren scoops it to Malachi Flynn. He fires it, falls. Malachi Flynn with a shot, sticks it.
Gotta take care of it.
Sasser's back with Flynn in the backcourt. Malachi Flynn, a double clutch three that's through.
With a three guard offense, because you don't want to take Flynn off the floor. Look at this, folks. Defender trailing, feels the contact, elevates, gets nothing but the ball.
Rebound to James Wiseman, top side to Flynn. And why not? He's hot. Here he goes down the lane of the rim, lays it up, lays it in, off the high glass.
Number 14, here he comes. I mean, he's just reading everything perfectly, and he's got the requisite ball handling skills to trick guys, especially when they're standing straight up. You know, you better be down in a defensive stance if you're going to stay with them.
Since the Pistons had that lead, it's a 39-16 run. Make it 39-18 as Malachi Flynn converts. With a rebound, races to forecourt. Malachi Flynn drives it, scoops it, scores it. It's 82-62. Malachi in the lane for two, and it's through.
There are times, George, when you get it going.
Ricci to the lane, lost the handle. Here comes Malachi Flynn down the middle to the rim, lays it up, lays it in a crowd. Malachi is down 15, Jaden Ivey spins. Topside Malachi Flynn, here's the long gun, it goes! Malachi still has it missed in the third. He now has a career high. Malachi. Way outside for Marcus Sasser. In the corner to Malachi, and the triple try is down.
Can't seem to cash it in, and then Atlanta does, and you're looking back up at a 14-point deficit.
Malachi Flynn off the high glass, and he hits it. Just about the time you exhale, he comes right back at you if you're the Atlanta Hawks.
Three dozen.
Here's Bogdanovich with a miss. Malachi with a rebound. He's doing it all. Malachi, stop and go to the lane, to the rim, flips it up, fills it up. What can Flynn do for you? Plenty.
Got a foul there, too.
Thanks to John Steinberg and company from Hawks PR for helping us research those numbers. Here's Malachi, and he rattles it in. Malachi Flynn has 40.
But George, you needed 44 shots to do it. Tonight, Malachi Flynn has 41, 18 shots, 19 shots.
Right here, he is running up another one and in from the baseline. With 3.5 left in his team, trailing 112 to 101. Malachi to the basket, scoops and scores.
He is making his kids play out there.
Murray to the baseline. Murray rises, fires short. Rebound Metu, hands to Malachi. Pull up, long gun from the top, it goes! Malachi splashes it down from downtown.
Smart play. Pulls up right there. That takes him to 48.
36 seconds left. Double team on Murray at the timeline. Ball dislodged ahead to Malachi. Lays it up, lays it in. 50 points for Malachi Flynn off the bench.
Nurk fighting with a rebound. The back tap to Booker. Book able to get to that free throw line, extended jumper, and gets on the scoreboard early here.
But when his mind is concentrated on scoring, he's difficult.
Book, quick trigger, pulls for three and gets it. C's put him in lockdown. Book with a pull-up three behind the screen, connects on his second triple of the night already. Yeah, it's been interesting. They've kind of played the role of facilitator between he and McCollum. Book sets, fires, wide open look, and triggered by that guy.
He's just hot, people. On. And Murphy is the one that's getting those looks based on how the Suns are guarding Zion.
He's played extremely well in the month of March. His Book, that time, little dribble hesitation on the perimeter.
And so I'm wondering when they're going to look at that in regards to making a change.
Book sees an opening and takes full advantage. First bucket of this second quarter, 26 now on the night. Steal. Quick advance pass to Booker out of the right wing. Get to that left hand, spinning baseline.
I mean, the crowd can only say, oh.
Would have rolled it. Better chance to scoop it off the floor. Book turns the corner, fading left of the lane, and cooking class has officially started here at the Smoothie. Seven on the shot clock. Back across the floor to Booker. Down to four. Book, sidestep three, high arching, rainbow connection. Over the outstretched hands of the defender.
You'll get on. Really? You'll get on.
No, cowboy boots. Cowboy boots, camouflage, stuff like that.
Book throws the defender, Jones, and knifing right to the basket. We will get embarrassed again tonight because of the way this New Orleans team has been playing. Book with a little leaner.
They were overplaying, and I would say the Suns got a ton of open threes. Devin might have had the toughest looks, but he's so hot it doesn't matter.
Gets a screen, raising up, firing, and connecting.
He's going after Grayson. That's what he's doing. And I shouldn't say anything, but, you know.
Willie pleading his case to Zach Zarbot as Book.
He's got 41, man. It's 21 minutes left in this game. Yeah, I've seen you on those commercials. The residuals must be really good.
4 of 11 from the field for Zion.
I thought McCollum did get away with a travel there.
On the drive and kick, Booker all alone in the corner. Make him pay the price, number one. Does play the passing lane so well. They were able to score on turnovers. Book with a beautiful high left hand over the stretched. Sees the double team come. Back to Durant. Tied up. Six on the shot clock. Booker with Daniels defending. Inside left hand finish. Give him a 50 piece.
Devin finally got loose there. Credit him. They've done a good job on Devin here in the second half, as you knew they would try to focus on. But
Daniels extends. Stepping out on Booker. Gets to the left hand. Scoops it up with a right hand. What a beautiful delivery. Right past the second year Aussie. 52 now.
This is a big time move here. I mean, Daniels thought he had the strip. He thought he had him blocked out. And then Zion right there. I just don't know how they think Grayson Allen can push him back.
Because people are wondering when the shoe is going to drop. But this team continues to win because of the young player as Embiid gets his first basket to go. Points in the paint, 29. That's all correlation because of how much attention as Embiid he garners. Anytime he touches the ball, all eyes are on him.
As we play here the final half minute in this opening quarter. Embiid the handoff to Hield as those two play the two-man game. And Hield, cash money with that mid-range J. Without SGA and Jalen Williams, this is the other Jalen Williams, not that time. Three chances and they come up empty. Embiid posting up, he was fronted and he makes it look easy. It's interesting, even at full strength, as you mentioned, Reggie, they change lineups, starting lineups, their rotations in game, sometimes they're, and Jalen Williams, their number two scorer, showing you just how deep and efficient this team is. Embiid, top of the key, Jay, cash money. OKC taking over sole possession of first place in the West with Denver and Minnesota right on their heels. That is Embiid. Again, they're the number one three-point shooting team in the country at better than 39%. Harris. Half-game lead over Denver and a one-game lead over Minnesota. Good interior defense with Embiid there and the loose ball corralled by Payne.
Remember, Chet Holmgren had eight of the first Thunder's 14 points, but hasn't scored since. Another block shot here on the evening for the Thunder.
Kenrich Williams, another undrafted piece. Harris corner three, that's good.
And these guys just can't come into the gym and just have practice threes.
Well, it's a tough bounce pass, Embiid. Little kind of scoop bounce underneath to Batum. What a beautiful pass as they find Batum. But you saw Englund, the shot doctor who has worked with so many franchises over the years.
Chance here to tie with a two or take the lead with a three.
North Philly native. Join his hometown team after the buyout with Charlotte.
There it
that is.
That is
Embiid, and we are tied.
Every time down the floor, he's got to touch the ball. There's the foul on Joel Embiid, just hugging Jalen Williams. High screen and roll here.
Penalty situation, so that is going to put the Thunder at the free throw line, but Philly on an 18-7 run to tie this game with 3:11 to play. Joel Embiid getting the explanation from Murat Kogut as Jalen Williams readies at the free throw line. First game this season that Oklahoma City has been without both Gilgeous Alexander and the other Jalen Williams. And they've got a shot against the Sixers team that has been buoyed by the return of Embiid. Oubre clean strip, but Dort was out of bounds underneath. Nearly a defensive gem by Dort with 16 to shoot. Sixers trying to decide who's going to be the inbound man. It'll be Lowry underneath. Lowry, Oubre, Batum with Harris and Embiid. Lowry, the precision passer, and there's Oubre on a dive.
Chasing around Oubre, who's been absolutely on fire here in the second half.
First lead for the Sixers since the 7:50 mark of the second quarter. They were up 32-31. Here comes Dort, attacks, knocked out of his hands, and that's a turnover.
Good defense by the Sixers here. Golden opportunity by the Thunder. They're letting this slip away here. Giddy off the bench here for the Thunder, getting ready to check back in.
Oubre, pick and roll bounce to Embiid. Couple of fakes, he'll shoot. Back rim, no, and Dort gets it back to the Thunder. A one-point Philadelphia lead with 2:25 left in regulation. Dort's going to reset into the corner. Wiggins inside to Joe, the former Sixer. Dort, Holmgren going to fire. A little bit too much, and the rebound by Harris. 2 minutes left.
Slow it down. A little simple drag action, high screen and roll. Get the ball to Embiid at the free throw line.
Here's Embiid, top of the key.
Sending help.
Into the corner, Oubre. Low left, Harris, five to shoot. Harris turns, little bit short, over Dort, and the Thunder have it with 1:41 left. They're down one. Remember, no SGA, no Jalen Williams, their top two scorers. Who do they turn to? Wiggins. Into the paint, going to shoot the fade. And it's cleared by Embiid.
And they can't get Giddy into the game. No stoppage of play here. Someone to make a play on the floor for the Thunder.
Thunder out of fouls. Six to shoot. Embiid elevates. Misses badly, and Holmgren ahead of the field to Isaiah Joe.
Might call a timeout here just to get Giddy back in the ball game.
Joe's going to sling it short. Offensive rebound. Dort puts it back, and he's put the Thunder back in front. Boy, Lou Dort leaving it all on the floor down the stretch. 45 seconds. Harris from deep. Offensive rebound, Embiid. Embiid leans in, boy, taking contact. It's going to be on Jalen Williams, his fourth, so Embiid.
And he's exhausted. Look at this. Mm.
He has been sensational at the line this season, 88%.
Oh, look at him. He is absolutely gassed.
back and forth these two teams have got.
That remains to be seen.
What does Mark Degnall draw up here without SGA and Jalen Williams? Errant pass. Boy, Dort was there. Right spot. As they avoid the turnover. This is Giddey. Crosses over. Look at Embiid. A foot race with Holmgren backed contact. And Embiid headed back to the free throw line.
Where he's been special tonight. OKC, because of that unsuccessful challenge.
So the Thunder in the bonus now. Both teams out of fouls for the final 25 seconds. Three-point lead. And here we go, 23 seconds.
And if you're Nick Nurse, do you foul and send him to the free throw line? Don't give up a three.
Isaiah Joe, well short. Giddey saves. Back to Joe. He's going to shoot again. And it's last touched by Kyle Lowry with 7.9 left. How does Nick Nurse handle this? Giddey is the inbounder again. They're out of timeouts of the Thunder. Joe back to Williams. He's going to launch. Short. Fight for it. Harris has it. And the Sixers. Let's see if they're going to put some time on the clock. They are going to put Harris at the free throw line, so it's not over just yet. The Sixers trying to inch a little bit closer to the Miami Heat, the team directly in front of them in the standings, as they get set to hit the road for three.
Now Gordon around the horn to Jokic.
Down.
And Jokic tips it in. So the big tipper getting some work here early, Scott. Nuggets 5-2 lead. Now long range three is no good. And Jokic hustles out of the backcourt. Jokic on his horse. Jokic in deep. And he drops it up and in. Now Wimpy has it knocked away. Now Gordon's got it. Down the middle to Jokic. And he puts it away with the slam dunk. Timeout pop. Got the only 40-20 game that Scott mentioned. Inside. Off the rim, no good, and Jokic there with a follow.
Instead, he got slapped on the follow.
Jokic is out on the break. Here he comes. Oh, he rams it home. Take that!
They tried to stop Lamb the time before, and he didn't mess around that one.
You're going to try to block this one, you're going to have to get it quicker.
Well, Jokic, 10 points. Champagne. And threw it away. Jokic right there. For three. Got it. Blake Wesley and Zach Collins have come on for the Spurs. Now wide open is Brown, and he knocks it in. Well, Christian Brown is having a sensational March. 60-year man from Gonzaga, 27 starts, 35 games off the bench. Back cut. Oh my gosh! Can I get a hallelujah? Three dunks for Nikola Jokic in the first quarter. Jokic 12 points, 8 rebounds, 2 assists.
He wants to make that 3 though.
Jokic 3. Got it! Nikola Jokic.
Now all of a sudden the first unit's kind of coming in and playing down to it as well.
Biggest lead of the evening for the Spurs. Jokic with a little quarter, that's good. 54-53. Wemby, no. Porter's got it. Oh, and it's deflected. Goes to Jokic. And he drops it in. Nuggets ending on a 14-6 run. Now Jokic on the move. Missed it. Put it up and in. Boy, he's got such quick reaction. Jokic scoop it up and in on the backhand and a foul.
Protect himself. It was right by Wimby. There's the reach and the foul. But see, now he gets away from it. And again, the pass in the center, into the post, and everybody stands.
Jokic going to work, wheels into the key, drops it in. 25 for Jokic. Jokic thinking about the three. Now he attacks. Comes further over the top. He's got to create some distance to get away from Wimby, and did. Jokic eyeballing, dump it in. Until Gordon came flying. Jokic backing in.
puts it up and in. Well, he's got the softest touch in the NBA. Anything that hits the rim. Caldwell Pope, give it to Yoke. Put it up and in, and a foul. And Nikola Jokic will head to the line.
It's a good boost, but you take. So now Collins comes over the last second, but now his body's, as he comes back, is just going to go right into Nikola. But it's because of that penetration by Caldwell.
Poked away. Jones, no good. Mamu with the offensive rebound. Now corner three, got it.
Now Peyton Watson just got locked in by Mamu. It got too deep under the basket.
Well, 99-95 now.
Denver stuck on 99 for a while.
Jokic got to go to work and complete the play. A double. Peyton Watson for three. Nope.
See, if no one's going to make an open shot, it's kind of tough.
It's good strategy by the Spurs.
Absolutely.
Watson, rejection. Peyton Watson sending this one back. The Nuggets leader in block shots this season. Wimby back in. He comes back in with 20, 11, 7 assists, and 7 blocks. Gordon is back in. Trey Jones is 1 assist from a triple-double. That would be the 3rd for him. Mamu! Got it! And the Nuggets lead has been cut to 1.
And again, you missed 5 wide open shots. And now you put yourself in trouble again.
Get a double. Here it comes. Jokic, soon as he takes the dribble. Jokic. Porter for 3. Nope. Nuggets have gone cold. The skip pass. And the Spurs have the lead.
10-point lead just a minute ago. Is this 11-0 run? And just in wide open shots.
Nuggets were up 99-88 with just under 8 minutes to go. Christian Brown in the lane, no. Jokic follows it up, and Wemby's hurt. Nikola Jokic just passed Carmelo Anthony on the Nuggets all-time scoring list. He is now 3rd. Trey Jones has a triple-double, the 3rd of his career. And Wemby.
Wow.
Where he shoots 80%. There's the list. Dan Issel, Alex English, 2 of the great names all time. That's a Reggie Jackson back in. Wembanyama looking to give the Spurs the lead back. No, if he can't. So we are tied at 101. MPJ has tied his career high with 15 rebounds to go with 12 points. Now Jokic, and he threw it away. Jones, and he missed the layup. Tip no good, got it back. Branham no good. Porter, new career high. And the long pass is tipped out of bounds by Branham.
Yeah, threw it away.
Jokic has it. They missed him on the post. Now he's got it. Put it up and in. Well, that's a nice out-of-bounds play by the Denver Nuggets. 103-101.
Get San Antonio to switch a smaller guy.
Jokic with 38 now to go with 14 and 6 assists.
Well, KCP got beat. He's holding his hand.
Yep. He's been playing with an injured pinky for over a month, and every time he slaps down, there's some trauma there. Nuggets by 2, 10 to shoot. Baseline jumper, little bunny is good by Branham. Malachi Branham, 24 points. Made 10 of 19 shots. We're tied up at 103. Jokic going to work on Wemby. Put it up. No! Wemby says, get that out of here. Now corner three. That's no good. Wemby tries to jam it. And it's out of bounds. Last touch by the Spurs. Wow.
I think he had him right there. I thought he had him when he went back. You forget how long he is.
Eight blocks for Wemby. Reggie Jackson, floater in the lane. No good. Wemby, long pass. Wemby for three. And Jokic gobbles up the rebound. Mamu hacking Jokic. Gordon, will he take the three?
He didn't want it.
He's better in the right corner. Not as good in the left corner. Jokic in the lane. Good! 40 for Nikola Jokic. Nuggets by two, 1:15 to play. Crowd chanting defense. Can they get a stop? Wemby against Gordon. Wemby around Gordon. Put it up and in to tie it at 105. Toyota Locker Room is coming up next. Under a minute. Jokic. Reggie Jackson rejected. Wembanyama was there. Bounce pass, and it's off Gordon out of bounds.
Not sure what Reggie saw right there. Head fake, get Wemby on you. You got a little dish for a layup.
Nine right blocks dish for Wemby, Scott.
Yeah, you're not going to get over the top of that. That's a
no. He had the dump off to Jokic. He's got to take that.
Poor decision.
So the Spurs have it. We're tied at 105 with 42 seconds remaining. Wembanyama falling away, way short. Jokic another rebound. At 16 boards. Ahead to Brown. Oh, no! He passed it up. Out to Porter. Yes! Oh, my! What a turn of events! Greg Popovich trying to carve out a win in hostile territory. Spurs have it. Wemby guarded by Gordon. Wemby way out to tie. No good. And Gordon's got it. This evening at Philadelphia. Into Jokic. Jok to Reggie.
Wow, they're not fouling.
And Jokic.
He's trying.
Jokic trying to get the three-point opportunity here. Jokic, 41 points now. Jokic, 42, 16, and 6 for Jokic. Final 5 seconds, long-range bomb, no good. Tipped up, Wemby's got it, missed it, dunked it. And that'll be it. The Denver Nuggets hang on at home and win it 110-105.
The NBA and how to adjust their game.
It's making a big time difference. That's good feet underneath AD once, twice. He'll get credit for a rebound and a tap in.
First quarter.
He had all 19 of his points in that first 12 minutes. Aggressive.
Lakers now shooting 56%.
Good steal by Prince.
Yeah, I mean, they're not getting opportunities. What a pass!
Underneath Davis, counted and one! Great vision by LeBron.
And then his left hand off the dribble. That's not an easy pass to make that accurately.
Go to the dribble. Gets bumped from behind by Abdia, who missed the shot a moment ago. Dinwiddie wants Davis, finds Davis. 25 to go. And he turns, and he gets a rebound. He's going to score this one.
Backhand! Dunk! Slam dunk!
We had another look at Anthony Davis missing the first and then saying, well, I'm not going to miss this one. It just looks a little bit like the Jordan Poole goal.
Yeah, try to force things a little bit. I give it up at that point.
Yeah.
Christie. Oh, good fade. Max Short. AD again and again and again so far here.
Davis just controlling the paint here as he waits for the miss from Max Christie and then just cleans it up easily.
Rui down the right-hand side, looks around. Oh, AD wants the basketball badly, and now he gets it. He was down low where he does more damage with another bucket.
That's very easy.
AD. AD still. Kuzma's right there. LeBron takes a dive right there. Can't get it, but it's going to be a score on the turnaround jump shot.
Yeah, you mentioned that.
Yeah. Elbow straight to the temple, the side of the head. That's a good entry. Now to Davis. Going down, big fella. Oh, we've only had one lead change in the entire game. That was early after watching.
Once you get it there, that's when you have to attack.
Yeah. He sealed it and scored.
As soon as you get it inside in the paint, that's when it's at the side of the board on corner threes.
Austin was fortunate. He got it right back and scored out of it. Kispert blocked by Davis.
Saved by Davis.
Play as Anthony Davis just gets a piece of it and then tracks it down, throws it, and saves it to LeBron. That's the kind of block you like to see.
Cito back to LeBron. Playing a little keep away. And LeBron bounces to 80 to finish with two hands. And by the way, fans, we've entered the final 5 minutes of the game.
And the whistle did not sound.
They swallowed the whistle. 80! Wow. Exclamation point.
Davis cutting down the lane. Another off the dribble left-hand pass. Boy, when you don't have to take that second hand to the ball to make the pass.
All orchestrated by Giannis. Jaren just pulls him over to get the finish on the interior. Jaren Jackson Jr. Yeah, he tried to go for the steal, but how about this move here? Is Jaren just able to dislodge?
Jaren spins through the double team and scores anyway. And they are going to call it on Giannis.
What's the degree of difficulty on this? The spin there, and it's off of the spin.
Clark. Jaren, two-man game, lob for BC. Pocket pass, Jaren banked it in, and the Grizzlies have the lead back. Not sure what we had, but his attention to detail, his work ethic, his desire to not just be good but great, that's what's elevated him to MVP status, Jaren, with a bank shot. And to that point, that's how you get to be a multi-MVP, Jaren with a hook. Long everything. But turned aside that time.
Rim didn't want that one. Nice.
Pippen. Great look ahead from 15 feet tonight. A little bit of a look away. And Scottie Pippen Jr., the beneficiary.
We can get away with those type things.
So the Grizzlies down three. Jaren going to challenge Lopez on the other end and finish.
You know, I said the matchup. Right now the Grizzlies recognize.
Goodwin. Jaren spins, hooks, hits again. 19 for Jaren Jackson Jr.
Little jab step, mid-range jumper.
Portis is just in a nice rhythm right now offensively. Jaren again attacking, banking, and hitting Jaren Jackson Jr. Jaren with 21. 11 here in the quarter.
Nice
spins,
move.
Faces up, fills it up. Holy cow. Jaren Jackson Jr.
You see, a nice drop down to Jaren. Takes his time, gets himself a little bit deeper into the
Grizzlies. They have a 1-point lead thanks to the Goodwin follow. Grizzlies 10 second chance points. Jaren drives on Lopez, lays it up and lays it in.
And as long as they could, long
the
as
double out of Adetokounmpo and Green had an open look as a result, but could not put it down. Bucks have finally dipped below 50% on threes. Here's a Jaren three. Bango! Jaren Jackson Jr. with the triple.
And the best player on the floor.
First three-point make for Jaren tonight, and it comes at a big moment. Couldn't reel it in.
Oh, good
and
hands
LaRavia with a knockaway. Grizzlies with numbers the other way. Jaren Goodwin knows where his
for Jordan Goodwin.
Well, like you do. Jaren's like, okay, I'm just gonna stand here. I'm
up to get the tip outs on that end.
Bucks 13 offensive rebounds. Jaren works against Lopez. Cooked him again inside.
Brook Lopez. And expect a quick double team.
Shot clock down to six.
Here it comes.
Jaren. A baseline fadeaway. Three, bingo. Holy cow. What a shot from Jaren Jackson Jr. Shooting in the dagger. With Grizzlies, wow. Their largest lead of the night and the toughest shot Jaren's had all night.
In his third year out of USC, he's healthy, three straight 20-point games. That's the longest stretch this season. Durant knocks down the foul line. Jay, first points for KD. Got Strus on him. Strus, a very willing defender. Booker, though, tough shot. His first attempt of the game goes down. That ties it at seven. Beal averaging seven assists over his last 10 games. See him give it up there to Durant. Good matchup here. And that's excellent defense. Better offense by Durant with a switch. He started for the injured Mitchell at last night anyway at 26 points. And the win over Utah. Another Cleveland turnover. Durant in transition. The short fall away goes down for Durant. He's got six.
Let's just watch him in transition. He's got LeVert backing up. Gets below.
The other, by the way, is almost 40. LeBron James.
Right.
Durant misses. Nurkic gets a big offensive rebound. Second chance. Bucket for Devin Booker. And we touch in the open on the 52-point game in New Orleans. It's his third 50-point game in his last three games against the Pelicans. Durant in transition with a slam. Booker the assist. Timeout.
Doc basically challenged his team and questioned their professionalism, saying they're not coming with the right disposition on the road. And now at home against Memphis?
Booker on Monday at 24 first quarter points, 37 at halftime. He's got nine already in this game. His skip pass is picked off by LeVert. Good hands up by Beal. Great hustle with the save and hits the cutting Booker for two. After spending the last 3 years with Miami, big part of their run to the finals last year, Durant going to take it, and he drills it. Boy, there was contact, too. Son of a coach, dad a longtime assistant at USC. Durant with the mid-range pull-up.
Where expectations meet reality. Dave, DB.
Their final 10 games are against playoff teams as Durant scores again. He's got 15. Largest lead of the game at 21. Good hands by Durant with the strip. Booker will try the three. That's good. It's a 24-point lead. Durant sizing it up. Looking to drive on Mobley, who's an excellent defender. Durant falling down. It doesn't matter.
In his career, and yet he just continues to electrify with his offensive ability. Takes some contact.
So here's Devin Booker, who's got 68 points in the last six quarters. He'll fire a three and hit. Devin Booker with his third three. He's got 19 in the first half. Mentioned Phoenix trying to climb the standings. Cleveland with a win would be just one game back in Milwaukee for the two spot in the East. Kevin Durant comes out firing and hits.
Playing off your defense.
Almost a turnover there. Sloppy pass. 9-0 run by Cleveland. Booker to the bucket. Count it and one. 3-point chance here for Devin Booker.
Now Devin Booker understands how to navigate, use his dribble, finding consistency individually, collectively. First half, they show you who they can be as Kevin stems the tide just a little bit here.
Garland. Blew the layup. Rebound Durant. Long pass down court to Booker. Stops and puts it in. Lead is 15 for Phoenix. Durant has been big here since Cleveland made that run. Booker mid-range shot goes down. Five straight empty possessions by Cleveland. Durant off the bounce. That's money over George Niang. Durant 25.
18th turnover, fourth for LeVert.
Booker with the step through, hang and finish. What a gorgeous play by Devin Booker. Beal, 5 points, five assists, five rebounds. Just six shots taken. Booker, with Beal recognizing Booker's got the hot hand, finds him in stride for another basket. 34 for Booker. The Suns trying to get out of the play-in and into sixth place, which they will be tonight if they win this game. Here's Durant for three. It's good. Playing last night, empty possession again for Phoenix, but Bol Bol able to pick off that pass from Strus. That was a big play there by Bol, and Durant with the layup. He's got 32. Starters are still out there for both teams. Booker, who's got 34 points, looking for his first basket of the fourth quarter, and there it is, a three. And they force a turnover in transition. Booker, quick catch and shoot. He wanted 40. He got 40, and that's the dagger.
Tyler Hero and others. Rozier, a new addition as well, has added a dimension to this Heat lineup.
Tyrese Maxey splitting the Heat defense and laying it up and in for our first points tonight.
Go back up with it. Good execution from your Sixers initially.
And good defense by Kyle Lowry. Knocked it away from Rozier. Maxey with it. Tyrese, step back three, and Tyrese is feeling it early tonight down here in Florida. Lowry, of course, spent a couple of seasons here in Miami. And it's Jimmy brother. Butler was like a brother. Embiid swishes his first attempt tonight.
Presenting himself with opportunities to score.
First time we've gotten to see this battle this season. Embiid, back-to-back jumpers for Joel Embiid.
The coach, they'd live with the jumper as opposed to the drive.
Embiid, straight-on triple, nothing but net for Joel Embiid. By the Sixers so far tonight.
Active hands, contesting everything. Wow.
Maxey, speaking of tremendous, how about 12 in the first quarter for Tyrese Maxey? Tightness has been a lovely high 70s, low 80s the last couple of days. What a move! What a move by Tyrese Maxey!
That's a tough make for Adebayo.
Paul was good for 12 and 9 in Tuesday's win. Tyrese Maxey, the teardrop.
Doesn't need to get to the basket.
Way too strong. Adebayo tried to tap it in, but could not do so.
No open looks for the Heat players. Sixers challenging everything.
Embiid, the finger roll and the foul. I pointed it, right?
Beautiful.
Maxey to Embiid. Joel Hans Embiid from downtown.
And the shoulder slump from Adebayo just a little bit.
This is where I remind everybody they were the highest scoring duo in the NBA before Joel went down. Batum knocks it away to Lowry.
So smart is Nico.
Maxey for three. And eight of those points and three of those turnovers came in the final 40 seconds of the first quarter and the second quarter.
Shows you how important it is to finish up quarters, finish up periods.
So important to have this guy back. Embiid swishes the J. Butler guarding Embiid again. Nicely done by the reigning MVP.
Pretty good defense from Jimmy forcing that fadeaway with that length, that left arm getting a piece of that Rozier shot.
Maxey weaving his way around the Paul Reed screen. Holy cats, what a play!
Physically, especially when he's going up against guys like Joel, but in this lineup, he'll do.
Look at Tyrese Maxey. Look at Tyrese Maxey.
That's like dancing right there.
Embiid, the no-look to Maxey. J.J. Martin tracks it down after Batum knocked it up. Tyrese has another go and does not miss that time. Needed that one, and Tyrese Maxey delivers.
Trying to probe that zone. Ooh, almost walked.
Tyrese, a tough step back, and Tyrese swishes another. 33 and counting.
Put it right in front of the defender, who was able to grab it from his hands.
Oubre fakes the three, gets downhill, lays it up and in. A big bucket from Kelly Oubre.
Sixers haven't done that in a while, attack the rim like that. They've settled for medium-range jump shots. That's one of the first drives, and it's paid off for them.
And six, the Heat lead trimmed to two. Rozier for three. Off back iron. Oubre the rebound.
Here's the key. Now that they give the ball to Rozier, can he deliver down the stretch when it matters most? He's really good in the first three quarters.
Oubre for three. Five quick ones. And it sure is live here down in Miami. Sixers' first lead since they were up 87-85 with 41 ticks to go in the third quarter. 3:20 to play in the fourth. Right, shadowing Rozier. Rozier in a step back three, short, long rebound back to him. Daring spins away from Lowry, keeping his dribble. Going left, coming back right. Ooh, almost travels, and Rozier leaves it short, and Maxey has his ninth rebound tonight.
He will force shots, too, will Rozier. That time, perhaps a little bit forced, but let's give the defense some credit as well, getting a hand up and challenging anything you put up.
Maxey a rebound away from his first career triple-double.
Joel fronted.
Maxey, baseline, money for Tyrese Maxey.
Some of the Sixer fans in the crowd getting up on that jump shot, waving their fists in their hands.
35 and counting tonight for Tyrese. Had one of his worst showings of the season here on Christmas. He knew he was never going to let that happen again. Adebayo short, Lowry clears.
Forcing the ball out of Butler's hands, making others beat you. Let's see whether or not they can. It was Rozier who came up short. Adebayo that time not able to score as well.
Maxey and Embiid. Adebayo on the big fella. Shot clock about to expire. Embiid leaves it short. 45 to play. Martin driving baseline. Rozier back to him. Martin trying to hand it to Butler, had it deflected. Oubre sheds Butler and lays it up and in. What a moment for Kelly Oubre Jr.
That's a good, strong move, using his hips instead of his shoulders. That's a smart play for you youngsters out there. It's not as obvious to the referee what Kelly's doing, but he was able to get Jimmy off of his back.
Butler tied up by a couple of his former teammates, and we've got a jump ball with 1:18 to go, and the Sixers up five.
Watch Maxey here with Rozier on him. Creates that separation, gets the shot off along the baseline, and then this Sixers defense jarring that ball loose and then just being stronger. I didn't even see that. That's awesome.
Right on.
A couple possessions have had Kyle Lowry on Jimmy Butler, and it has worked well, denying him the ball, and then when he does get it, forcing him to get rid of it and have others try to beat you. It has not worked.
Embiid taps it back to Oubre.
Main objective, get the ball out of Jimmy's hands.
Maxey content to take his time. Rozier on Tyrese, and now Butler switches on to him. Lowry, Embiid for three. Way too strong. Highsmith there on the weak side. 50 seconds to go. Lead five for the Sixers.
No foul, especially jump shooters.
Martin doesn't foul, and it's a good thing he did not, because Rozier has his sixth triple tonight.
Such a tough shot.
2-point Sixers lead with 35 seconds to go as the crowd rises to its feet.
A bucket would quiet him, though.
Maxey, long two, short. Miami with a chance to tie or take the lead here. And a 2-second difference between the clocks. Maxey all over Rozier. Lowry there as well. Ties him up. Butler with seven to shoot. Jimmy Butler pulls up, round and off. Highsmith had the rebound. Maxey picks it up, and that will almost do it. Rebound, a rebound away from his first triple-double, but I think Tyrese will take the dub instead. Maxey gets the roll. Whew, nervy times for that guy. Sixers 0.5 away from win number 42 on the season, and a third consecutive for Nick Nurse and the Sixers.
There's Maxey willing it in the basket, and then a little jig afterwards.
Two big ones from Tyrese Maxey, and it's a four-point game.
Two-possession game, spot on. Good win for your Sixers, good win.
A massive victory for Nick Nurse, Tyrese Maxey.
Amari Smith Jr. missing that as Steph heads into the front court. And they had lost to two sorry teams.
No, lost to Dallas and Minnesota.
Steph Curry with a three. I think against Amen Thompson, he could do some damage in his own right scoring. They don't have Şengün at center, so they're playing small. Steph with a running one-hander with the right hand.
Everybody else is able to get to work and kind of carry him down. He's like, I'm getting off to a great start here. Thompson is a one-man wrecking crew in the open court.
Play. That's a one-man fast break for three off a made layup. Together against Dallas in 48 minutes. They have 11 in 4 minutes here in Houston to start the game. Trayce Jackson-Davis and Draymond together defensively. It gives the Warriors their best 4-5 defensive pairing. Play from the corner. Back-to-back threes. Klay Thompson. Ime Udoka knows.
He told me too. I didn't know Nelly was coming too.
Yeah, it's going to be a great show. Klay Thompson. So a missed free throw becomes a 3-point trip. And the Rockets 0 for 4 from deep. The Warriors more than content to let him fire from out there.
But that was respect for Draymond Green, that Jalen Green pulled that one back out, didn't attack him.
How about Trayce Jackson-Davis? What a find! Justin and Aaron and the talent level there.
Boy, they're on a journey to get it.
Three of them were excellent. Klay Thompson is excellent. He's got 14. Play with Trayce. Pretty good defensive end, Thompson. It didn't matter. Chris Paul knows. Klay is this hot. It's an ISO over Aaron Holiday. No, come on. Come on!
Two with the ball, and Chris Paul is rotating over. But the problem with that is he's so much smaller than Jabari Smith.
And Jalen Green and Jabari Smith. Steph laying it up and in. Curry. Deep three, Draymond Green. What a rebound. And somehow found it back. Steph at midcourt. Steph down the lane to lay it in. Two-man jumping Steph. The roller. Trayce Jackson-Davis. He'll take the foul. He'll lay it in anyway.
Trayce is the beneficiary. Just roll out of that. Two defenders stay up. I know Dylan Brooks is rotating over. You make the adjustment. Trayce has got it like that. He spends a lot of time in the air.
Quality teams close quarters. That's how you win on the road. The Warriors are 14-3 in their last 17 road games. How do they close the second quarter? Klay Thompson's got 21 and a half.
Dylan Brooks has helped, it has to be said. You know, no matter what happens at the end of this season, they got a chance to double their wins. It'll be tough to do because they got to go 6 out of 7. And Steph knocks down a rainbow three.
Klay attacking. And a great delivery there. Beautiful by Klay Thompson and Andrew Wiggins.
Dylan Brooks hadn't really been much of a factor. 2 points, 1 for 6, and hacking people.
Klay Thompson got 24 and 6 made threes. He's 20 years of age. He just keeps getting better and better.
And that three-point percentage is going to keep going up. He's 36 right now. He's at some point going to be above 40.
Klay Thompson again!
Oh, he was staring someone down before the game.
Oh, your voice carried like that.
You can't stare people down and then do nothing in the game.
That's a great play by Trayce Jackson-Davis.
But the Warriors are doing a great job of balancing their attack. They're not just relying on them.
And Thompson undersized and just the bulk of Trayce Jackson-Davis forcing that baby hook short. Steph all the way to the iron to lay it up and in.
Are calling him and asking him to teach them
absolutely
some post moves.
But this is also an elite scorer who was also Defensive Player of the Year. Steph Curry, an elite scorer, flipping that up and in. And upon the final minute here in the third. Play from the foul line. Man, has he had it stuck on automatic. 11 of 15 for 29. Whitmore is just holding on to Steph Curry. Play to Trayce. Is executed incredibly well.
You see they're trying to do a little more work on the glass, get some extra possessions.
Here's Paul Klay, Trayce Jackson-Davis, Moody, Pajemski. And Trayce is just wrecking shop in the second half.
Well, Klay is wrecking shop. But two defenders are staying with him, and he's hitting Trayce at exactly the right time. Those two have an amazing rapport.
Well, that's why does Klay say that? He said
that. Talk about diagnosing a game.
Reggie Bullock, you saw him in Dallas for years, and Steph went right around him.
His handle is elite.
You know, this lead was 4 coming in with the tiebreaker. It'll be 5 with only 6 games left.
There's some teams ahead of the Warriors as Steph gets inside again. He's still working.
From Minnehaha Academy in Minneapolis. Next time the Warriors play, Chet Holmgren and Jalen Suggs were teammates in high school. Player, 3 ball, Brandon Miller.
players to try and spoil opportunities for playoff teams.
It's really big.
Oh, another one. Back-to-back threes, Brandon Miller. And Jamal Mosley has to call a timeout.
Vaquero made an all-star team this year. Second pro season out of Duke.
Brandon Miller puts it in his eye. Just raised up and hit it for the free throw line. Miller hangs and hits. Brandon Miller's got the last 10 with a chance to make it 11.
Speed up the floor via the pass, and the Magic never got organized defensively. Look at body control, shot making ability.
Kind of Pogsian, if you will.
I'm telling you, man. No doubt.
Woo! Brandon Miller swirls in his third three-pointer of the first quarter.
Joe Griffith was the best to ever come out of Iowa until Caitlin Clark happened.
Oh.
Brandon! Yes! Ecstasy for Brandon Miller! He's 6-for-6 on the pass.
Look at Brandon work. Let him work off of that screen. That's Fossa just standing there. And you got a hot guy, you just stand there and let him work off of you.
Oh,
throws it right in the folder.
Swooping left-handed hook missed by Vaquero. Easiest two of the ball game, Brandon Miller. He's got a new career high for points in a quarter. That is points 18 and 19, Dell.
We're going to talk to her in a little bit as well, guys.
Thank you, Ashley. Congratulations, Shelby. Brandon Miller, oh my goodness! The lane opens up for him. Brandon Miller, oh my goodness! Crunching pick sent by Grant Miller, and it results in three for Brandon. 9 from the field, 5-for-5 from behind the arc.
Look at that screen right there. Right in the ear hole, Wagner. And Milliken
got his own miss back. What? Miles Bridges just wanted it more. Here's Brandon, he's gonna be 10-for-10. What a half for the rookie.
Look at that block right there from behind. And Beaches says, oh, there's my guy. He's all alone. Lay that one in easily.
Yep, let him shoot. Markel Fultz to miss fire. Hornets have numbers if they want it. Brandon Miller. Yes! He's got a curry. I can smell it, folks.
Look at that pass by Beaches. Left hand right off the dribble. Brandon hanging in the air and then adjusting the basketball around Vaquero.
Oh, gorgeous.
Ability here at the NBA level. 15th pick in the draft. He's right now up to a career-high 15 again.
Look at his pass.
Inside, deep catch. Just takes his time inside as Vucevic.
Yeah, so that's what we talked about. The pace, the fact that Poole does not wait on you to get back before he attacks. So after the great pass from Scoot and the finish from D.A., Poole scores. D.A. says, let me get that two back. Where he has over 8 games as a rookie of at least 20 points and 10 assists.
So his second foul, here's Walker on an inside-out number. Position to Oklahoma City, was an assistant with Scott Brooks on P.J. Carlissimo's staff. And then later with Scott.
Good pass, there you go.
D.C. inside, deep catch by Aiden. 3:53 left here in the first period. Aiden drops it to Rupert. Stands still, triple up and in. That three has been looking good, Lamar.
Yes, it has. You just look for the ball, go find it, go get it.
Banton off the brush screen from Aiden. He slips, he rolls, he misses the shot, grabs his miss, and flushes with two hands. It's Ryan, and we got into a big squabble about this. And Eagle just got so flummoxed, he walked away. He says, now you're going to tell me it's not Murray, it's Murray. The typical Eagle fashion. How about that lob inside there?
Agreed on.
He did?
Yeah.
He was playing on a two-way. He's got the standard NBA contract.
He's really, really good. He just has not gotten that opportunity that shows his best stuff as D.A.
Banton will give it up. He is pressured in backcourt. Now Eaton sees some pressure. Champagne up on him. Banton draws two, finds Aiden wide open, and drills a 15-footer.
That right there from D.A. shows all the promise in the world. And to fully guard him in that corner and forcing another pass back. The more passes you can force as a defense, the more time you have to catch up. Speaking of catching up, they can't catch up to D.A.
No, what a drop.
Go for the spin. Yeah, that was nice.
He is up to 19-9.
They couldn't do nothing with him on this one. He's been shooting 32.5% from the three-point line, and that is the lowest percentage among players who have attempted at least 4,400 three-point shots.
Forced to fade. The pressure defense. Blazers the other way. Rupaire, long arms and legs. Off it comes to Murray. Bouncing to Ayton. Right down the chute for a two-hand jam. The Wizards forgot about number two. Here he comes, working with the left hand. Forced to pivot away to Reef. Over to Ayton. Gets rid of it with two to shoot. Gets nothing but net. DeAndre Ayton, 28 tonight and 10 boards. Avia there to show a body. Gill is up top as well. And here's Ayton with it. He squares up. Got rid of it in a hurry. What a quick dribble handoff to Banton. Nine to shoot. Swing it out on top to Scoot. 6'9". Avdia on him. Popping out is Ayton, and he tosses one up and scores.
He does have 7 rebounds and 4 assists, so that's been good, but he's got 5 fouls now.
And that's just the fifth field goal for that starting lineup for Boston. It was really their bench that came in and did a great job. Shot a perfect 5 of 5 in the first quarter.
Those numbers would stack up the same way against a lot of teams in the NBA, to be fair.
This has just been an incredibly difficult matchup. Nice job by De'Aaron Fox going after that.
From deep this year. Fox touches the paint. Nice in and out dribble and bucket. Oh, a lot of jelly at the rim by De'Aaron. And the rebound by Vazenkov.
I don't know if the first one was a pass or a shot.
Horford switches on to Fox. Fox knocks down his first three of the night.
This Boston Celtics team, you dug yourself a bit of a hole, so you got to string together some stops.
Fox around the screen. Hits another three. That's two in a row for Fox. Way out beyond the three-point line. Fox working on the catch. Now the bounce. Got by Tillman. Got it to fall.
He didn't look like in year 7 of his career.
Wonderful comparison, Katie. And Keegan projecting well. Fox with another three, laces another one. And the pugnacious nature right here of De'Aaron Fox at the offensive end that time. Peyton Pritchard off the mark, and Sacramento can make it a 7-point game. Fox looking to attack. Like I said, looking to attack. Feels that way. Fox loose, pulled out the giant killer, got it over Porzingis.
Gained some consistency.
Murray back out to Sabonis. Porzingis wasn't buying the fake. Fox for three. Splash! The Celtics are flying right now. Lyles out to Edwards from deep. That comes off to Ellis. Tipped it to Fox. Blows by Hauser. He's got the skills to pay the bills.
You gotta do it.
He's had a rough couple of games there. Didn't score at all in the game last night against the Knicks. Richard probing all the time. Kicks it out. Ties it 1 for 13, 1 for 14. Oh, nice move. Cut. And a foul will get Hauser to the free throw line.
Man, Cornette is really good at that high post.
Final 5 minutes of tonight's game, presented by Eastern Bank. Join us for Goo. Sabonis with a breakaway two. The lead at 14, under 5 to go. Celtics got a busy week coming up.
I think it'll be really interesting to see how they do the Milwaukee game on Tuesday. You know, you have Portland on Sunday.
Right here.
Yeah. And I think, you might see some guys out, but other guys will come back in.
Yeah.
And then, just like how to play. Like, will they send everybody there?
To Milwaukee?
Will they show Milwaukee a bunch of different looks? Why would they?
Why would they do that?
You would want to keep that in your back pocket, so... It's a lazy way out to analyze, say, our bench isn't good.
Hauser off the catch. Pulls up. said he was going to try it again.
That's what I thought.
Pritchard will try it. He's got a hot hand. Oh, Casey and Crowder got whacked in terms of it.
Here we go.
Here we
Hauser.
Go.
Here.
No, it's definitely not as nice. Stop hitting me.
Sometimes. Well, those are the ones that can get you going.
Can you back?
No, I can tell he's a little gun shy this last 6 minutes. A little bit. It only takes one, Mike.
Wow, that's a tough shot.
Yeah, sure was.
98-86, a 12-point game. Set. Barnes defending. Cornette looking for his buddy. Finds him. Pritchard. Pull up. Uh-oh. Cornette's going to get the foul. Little bit dangerous.
Here are the numbers for Sabonis, as you can see, 15 and 14. Six assists. Won't get the triple-double tonight. He keeps that double-double streak alive tonight.
I haven't seen a wave in a long time. What's going on in the building right now?
Yeah, I think every time we get up by a lot, it's like the new Geno.
It's the new Geno.
Okay.
Tillman can't use his strength.
Dangerous place right here.
I mean, nothing. Jones, little handoff. Foul on Walsh, I guess.
You know, you have to assume. This is that whole thing when a team is on a run, you go to the stars. Like, yeah. Right now, they got a comfortable lead. It's kind of a sneaky big possession.
Uh-oh. John moves to the hoop there.
Oh, Missoula's going to have a conversation.
Right back. Pritchard gets a screen, gives it back.
Yep, for Hauser.
Hauser swallowed up.
Big defensive possession.
A three goes.
Oh. All right.
98-92 possession game now.
This game's getting a little interesting.
Set. Gets to the free throw line. Thought he had it.
With our guys in the game and with that stake for Sacramento, this is like a big time game for Sacramento.
Yes, yeah. Sure is. Fox. Attempt a two minute game between Sabonis and Fox.
Yep.
Kick to the corner. Looking for a three and knocking down a three. Harrison Barnes, 99-95.
Less than 2 minutes. 16-1. Now I'm going to Peyton Pritchard.
Attempt to double team for Hajduk. Gets it back. Hauser, no. Offensive board.
Terrible.
I think he did something wrong. Fox.
Oh,
that would have been really tough.
This right here can win us the game, this possession.
Pritchard off the dribble, nearly lost it, gets it to Hauser. Gets it back now. Back to Hauser, takes it.
One. That's all right. Just first foul in the last 2 minutes, so Sacramento has to still earn it.
4-point game. Under a minute.
Man, he's quick.
He's
quick.
He's got two, and it's 99-97.
It's getting interesting. Come on, Peyton. Deliver this win right here. There you go. Come on, crowd.
Pritchard
off the bounce. Hesitation in the lane. Blocked from behind. Fox takes a three. Bank it home.
Joe's going to let him figure it out. Joe says no timeout.
Pritchard in the lane. Stuck there. Hauser, can he be the man? No whistle. Hill, knocked down. Tillman. Here he comes.
Wow.
Pulls up. Can't get it home. Loose ball put up and no. Kick. No. Boston wins the game.
This is a really good basketball team, man.
Good defense on the Draymond Green drive and miss. P.J. Washington running the floor. Puts it up on the rim and a nice fall. 4-for-4 to start the game for Dallas.
Green. And in the open court, I think where he will
ultimately. Yeah, he's ag.
Kevin Scott was nice enough not to team up there. And that is P.J. Washington Jr. How high his confidence is up right now. Gafford's presence on the offensive boards. Going to work. Opts for the kick out. And it's Washington again. 3J hits it. One.
Things are going well for you.
Two.
You don't have to think.
Dallas stays with it. Washington with the board. Now he wants another three. 3-for-4.
That's
this
confidence.
Dude has found his shot, and that's why he is smiling.
You just pull up and let it go. That's what he's doing right now.
He's too good of a player, Harp, to be. P.J. made three threes in the first quarter, and it's time to let P.J. Washington cook again.
Get back. They got numbers.
14 points in the game for Washington to lead Dallas. Kyrie has 11, and another defensive play made by the Mavericks. And it's some windshield wiper basketball right now.
Played well in Houston last night as well. Had 29 points.
Yes, he did, and so did Steph. Inside, P.J. scores.
Well, they both had 29 last night.
17 is his season high, and P.J. Washington somehow came away with the pass. It looked like it was about to be taken away. He has now tied his career high in assists with 5, and he's had 5 assist games a couple of times this year, and then it's P.J. on the other end.
Bam, meets him up top, says, give me that. Well, that's a perfect block.
That was a really good hand by Jones because Jackson Davis had both mitts on the offensive rebound. Washington alertly wraps the pass around on a bounce to Kyrie and the pull-up. Hardaway. 5 minutes left of the third quarter. Hardaway has it again. Low clock situation now. 5 seconds to P.J. Washington in the paint. He scores! 21 tonight.
Washington Jr. started out knocking down threes. Now he's attacking, and the Mavericks are going to.
We have a coach's challenge.
Yeah, work that challenge.
P.J. was adamant that he didn't foul him.
21 points, 11 rebounds a game. Nice hand by Kyrie. He wants Exum to push the tempo. And Exum running. P.J. with him. Washington and one.
Defense to offense. You got to love it.
I wish the Mavericks would win this game. They're up by 5.
Well, there's a hand by Kyrie. Put the Mavericks out in the open court where P.J. wants.
I think it's
Jimmy. I don't know.
That's a great question.
That's that has not been on my mind lately. Look out here. Oh! Just like Jackson Davis. P.J. Washington. What you can do, I can do too.
Great defense. And
step on the move. Deflection. Steal. Dallas.
Yeah. More defense from the Mavericks.
Nice bounce pass in transition. Laser inside. Washington ducks under the defense. P.J., 26 points. Timeout, Golden State. Look out tonight.
And here's why. The Mavericks using their hands. P.J. Washington Jr. And then their defense has turned into offense. Tim Hardaway Jr. making the extra pass.
Jaden Hardy in the first half had 5 points. And for some fourth quarter run here, Curry. To Pajemski looking for the lob, and it's Payton.
It's just good offense.
and back-to-back.
Yeah, you're so worried about Steph Curry.
Yeah.
He's the one that gives you that opportunity to put you in position for that lob.
Well, here's a steal by Green. Those two dunks have brought about Daniel Gafford's imminent return to the game. He's at the scorer's table. Green a dunk, Payton a dunk. Deflected pass, deflected ball, steal Dallas. PJ, an open three, on the money!
He's just, there's no hesitation.
Don't call him PJ, call him 3J.
Supreme confidence. Such a confident player.
Called that zone, he's in that zone yes. right now.
He's gone sleep on the floor. That's what's happening.
Well, don't wake him up.
Don't do that. He's got 29 tonight. Ball from the corner. Airballs it. And out of bounds.
I think it's Mavericks ball.
Oh. They're saying Warriors. Angry fans.
Well, and everybody just looked at one another amongst the referees. That's a tough call to make.
It sure is.
Gets off Gafford. Maybe off his face.
And
blocked by Jones at the Steph Curry three. Oh, and a foul. A hard fall to the floor. He's going to shake it off. Man, Chris Paul getting very physical with P.J. Washington. They're trying to deny Kyrie. He scoops up the loose ball, looking for Gafford. And it is out of bounds.
It's kind of fire with fire.
P.J. applying pressure in the backcourt. Draymond to Klay Thompson. Short on the three. Now Steph Curry, though, with a follow-up. It's a seven-point game with 3:35 left. Got to keep on playing.
Yes, you do. Through everything.
Keep on moving. Keep it moving. Again, physical defense. Payton all up in the jersey of Kyrie Irving. Guy puts it down. Kept alive by Gafford, claimed by Paul, up to Curry. Numbers developing here, Curry all the way to the basket. He'll shoot two free throws.
That's what Derrick Jones is talking about.
United American Airlines Center this year, Steph missed the game when Dallas beat the Warriors here on March 13th. That was a 109-99.
Oh, this is going to be a white knuckler all the way down to the finish, baby.
Yes, it is. Squeaky bum time right now with 3 minutes to go, and the Mavericks lead down to five. They were up 10 earlier in the fourth quarter. On the bounce, Kyrie. Woo. Kyrie hounded by the defense. Late pass, Gafford, shot clock, back up. Let him know, big man, let him know.
It's called second effort.
Yeah.
And his second effort tonight has been outstanding.
Daniel Gafford. 10 points, 15 rebounds, 5 assists, 3 blocks. Curry loops it out to Draymond. And then Curry along the sideline. Forced up a shot, no whistle. Rebound Kyrie Irving. It's 4-4 right now. Jones got hit in the head.
Curry's tired right now.
He's slowly getting back into the play along with Derrick Jones Jr. Exum trying to break down the defense. Now to Jones. He's in the mix. He's taking it to the cup. Rebound Draymond off the missed shot. Up by 7. And it could be 5. It is. Could be 4.
Yeah.
Kyrie picked up 2 in the first quarter.
No more.
That's his third foul of the game.
Kind of what Luka did last night.
Now a 4-point game with 2 minutes left. 103-99. The Mavericks are 21-9 in clutch games this year. The best winning percentage in the NBA. The Dubs are 22-22. Hand off Gafford to Kyrie. Green guarding. Back to Kyrie. Now here comes the double team. Kyrie dribbles away from him. Pulls up late in the clock. And he hits the bullseye.
So clutch.
He wants the ball. He's going to get it.
He wants the ball. And he's going to do special things with the ball. Here's Curry. Jones is on him. Green. 90 seconds left. Cut to the basket. Payton barely enough oomph to get it in. That would have been a big miss had that rolled the other way.
We want to be strong with the ball right now against the Warriors defense.
119. Exum.
Payton guarding. Exum slithers up the baseline. Goes back inside. Tossed it up on the rim. Green a rebound. Oh, boy. Four-point game. Golden State ball. 1 minute remaining. Long three. Oh, my goodness. Timeout Dallas with 58.7 left. 105-104.
So tough down the stretch of games. Just got to a spot and able to pull up and knock it down.
From the logo.
Well, Gafford laid back on the screen opposed to he got caught up. And Gafford didn't come out as Green set the screen. Which I think is crucial. A little bit under a minute to go.
Into Kyrie. Closing quarters tonight has been Golden State very good at the end of the first second.
Without a doubt.
Guy directing traffic over to Hardaway. He swings it to Jones. Back to Hardaway, 10 seconds. Dallas had a good close to the third, but now it's Golden State here in the fourth. They move it to Jones. Corner three. He comes up short. Golden State defended that sequence well. Now here's Curry looking for another three in the lead. It's no good. Oh, my. You hold your breath when those moments happen. Now Dallas in the open court. Here's Washington. And they got a blocking foul. Golden State does have a challenge.
They're going to use it. I mean, what are you going to save it for?
Yeah, it doesn't carry over to their game against Utah on Sunday.
No, they're going to challenge without question.
There's the miss. There's the rebound by Dallas. And then here is the play.
Is it enough to change it?
Let's see where Steph Curry is.
Well, he's in the restricted area.
Yes, his heel is in the restricted area. Well, and remember, this is very important to remember. When you pick your heel up off the ground,
that's still,
yes,
you're still in the restricted area.
Yeah, the sideline is a different deal, yeah, but you're in the restricted area when you pick your heel up off the ground. That plane of
the defender, Curry's right heel, was above the restricted area line at the time of the illegal contact. So therefore, it is a restricted area blocking foul. The challenge will be unsuccessful. Golden State will lose a timeout, and Dallas will shoot two shots.
Well, here's BJ.
That'll make these.
He is 2 for 4 now on the line tonight. They got one. 2-point game.
Boy, gotta get one stop.
They got one free throw. Now they need one stop. 19 seconds. Chris Paul slowly walked it up. They're looking for Curry. Curry, a step back on two. The game is tied with 12.4 left.
Kyrie time.
The Mavericks are opting to use their final timeouts.
What a game.
And the Mavericks want to go to Kyrie Irving. And it goes into him. Here comes the double team. Kyrie moves away from it. Hardaway, 7 seconds. Driving. Washington underneath. Lays it in. Lays it in. 4.5 to go.
Ooh, that's the way to attack.
P.J. Washington Jr. That man has been the best scoring Maverick from the start of the game until the end of the game. 32.
Give Tim Hardaway Jr. a lot of credit because he didn't try and force a shot.
To win the game, Dallas needs one stop. Paul in. Curry has it. 3 seconds. 2 seconds. Back to Paul. Over to Klay Thompson. It's no good. It's all over. It's all over.
LeBron. Two stints in Cleveland. Now D'Lo wanders down the middle, throws it up and in with the soft touch to start the game. Mobley thinking about it, spinning, he's underneath, and the Lakers take advantage this time. Middleman is LeBron, here he goes, bounce, D'Lo, score! James comes across the line, nobody's going to stop him, count it!
a live ball. It's the turnover again. The Lakers right in the passing lane, and you don't get a chance to get in front of him.
You got Reeves, AD. Here's LeBron. That one game on the trip where he had 9 threes.
But he's still very effective on the drive.
Boy, Jared Allen runs into a double team, maybe even a triple. Lakers strip it free. Reeves, good pass, under to LeBron.
So defensively, the weak side is going to have to be aware.
Lob, oh! LeBron, the lob in the jam as he came down the lane.
Reeves has it in the corner, just throws up a lob in the middle, and LeBron just elevates and throws it down with both hands. And that was Evan Mobley who was trying to guard him.
Cavs all-time leader in games, minutes, points, rebounds. Of course, he's dealt with some health issues, and it's great to see him on the floor and really flourishing. Count it, 80.
By that time, the weak side.
That started with a 30-point effort 5 games ago, and then it's gone down, 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 down. But he's having a really good quarter as D'Lo. Yes, sir. Nobody has led by more than 4. D'Angelo with 8 and the shot clock off for the quarter. He sets fire to yet another 3.
Tristan is back to the bench.
You know what? Morris has a twin, but he doesn't look like Tristan. Here it is on the other side. That's knocked down. Good move, but he couldn't finish it.
A good challenge also by Jackson Hayes.
Yeah, Jax is in the game. Of course, look for a dunk or 2 or 3 tonight or today. LeBron, boy, change of pace. Change of pace.
Play by LeBron is to change direction and right past Morris for the layup. LeBron with 11 on 5 out of 6.
Ball out of bounds. LeBron looking to get free. Does. Handling the basketball on the delivery on the inbound from D'Lo. Alone on the wing off D'Lo. You know, he kind of came out. Goes right to Austin Reeves. He's put up some decent rebounding games last month or so. Russell, catch, shoot, count it.
Impressed with the way the Lakers are not only shooting the ball, but moving the ball and their alertness for this early game.
Cavs had a 7-0 run that ended just a couple of moments ago. They're back at it with that Mitchell basket. Russell, boy, had the defender right on his hip. D'Lo literally waited for it to drop right into his lap. Then he'll shoot for 3. Fresh snow. What a half for D'Angelo Russell. You know, they haven't won 2 straight games since February. I told you, it's just win-lose, basically, for them. They're coming off of a loss, by the way, to Phoenix. And LeBron just kind of bullied his way in and scored.
This clock just winding down, looking at LeBron, just bouncing screws and finally gets into the paint where he wants to be.
Yeah, got a minute 20. LeBron underneath, down the middle, Davis!
Another look at that play where LeBron's falling out of bounds and spots the dive man.
56 as we get the second half going. See if the Lakers can continue this roll. They're looking for their 4th win in a row. And 9 out of 10. And Davis starts it off perfectly from the mid-range.
That rebound. Let's get another look at Anthony Davis. Setting him up for the turnaround fadeaway. Nothing but bottom. Pretty staff to this score.
I was waiting for your response. If they do score, they will call a timeout. Underneath, but they reject at the rim. Or did Allen just miss it? 5 assists. LeBron launches. It's going to come up well short, but the Lakers, the only one even close to that was Davis. Everybody else was Cleveland. He does some work and scores again.
Davis's effort on the miss by LeBron. He tracks down the long rebound and throws it up, ready to get his own miss. And a crowd lays it up, lays it in.
He surveys the floor. If they give him any kind of room, he'll try to get to the rim. Reeves behind the back. Bounce. LeBron. Here he goes.
About the one you missed. Just think about the one you're going to make and then the assist to Reeves.
About that all season long. Garland. Austin kicks it. And he saved it.
Oh, my goodness.
He saved it.
Oh, my goodness.
That's what saved it. Look at this.
That's
only
unbelievable.
Way he
that ends up in a Laker hoop by Anthony Davis. Yeah, hasn't scored in this game, but he's had his hands on a lot.
Davis, 3.
Timeout. Cleveland.
Isaiah, his brother's on the team.
That's the second shot of the half.
Lakers have been solid all year long here at home. In fact, they have the 4th most wins of anybody in the West. There it is! D'Lo. Although Spencer is hustling back to try and challenge, and they stop him.
That was all Austin Reeves.
Austin Reeves. How about that?
And it's
LeBron holds it high over his head. Out to Rui, but they have to shoot it. He does. And that was, AD. He just slid right in. Thank you very much. Off the chart for this Laker team. That's what happens when you play well. LeBron, just the joy of everybody right now, and the energy and the focus. And having Davis on your team, and LeBron!
Wow.
AD, doing the right thing. You got to play the games, and you do, and they've been playing great. Love to LeBron! LBJ! Beautiful!
I mean, that's just pretty.
Anything.
That was just pretty. Look at that touch on the pass, and LeBron still, look at that pop off the floor. I see your vision.
LeBron
in San Antonio to take on Wemby and company tomorrow. Here's Joel Embiid. Good looking step back from the big fella. Sixers lead 28-23, second quarter coming up. Just to separate the two, Jerry, one of those 13 Grizzlies not available tonight. Joel Embiid. Five quick ones from Joe. That one from beyond the arc.
Joel with five early points. We're going to show you three of them. The defender playing off of JoJo.
Expired. Goodwin pulls up short. Nico Batum the rebound.
Defense, that exchange. Good
great
pass.
Hit ahead pass indeed. Joel sees Kyle Lowry who lays it up and in.
I should say it looks like a full court three-man weave is what it looks like.
Buddy Hield and Nico Batum, the five on the floor for Nick Nurse and the Sixers.
A.J. Martin right now showing us his defensive prowess as Joel shows us his offensive prowess.
Embiid fakes the three.
Not much magic there either, though, to be honest.
Embiid from the free throw line. Back-to-back buckets for Joel Embiid, and he's our first player tonight.
Let's JoJo the other end of the floor here, just sizing up, getting into rhythm, using that rhythm dribble. Defender on his heels. JoJo with Boston Garden, where it was designed that way. Over 60 years of never changing it. The court.
Oh, Embiid! What a block on Jemison.
On both ends of the floor. Watch this. Jemison going up. Joel with other things in mind. The quick denial. One more look at it.
Yes.
Doesn't even leave Jemison's hand.
2 minutes to go in our first half in Memphis. Embiid, tough turnaround from the free throw line. He was pushed, no whistle.
Carve out a little space, watch Joel here. Fades away on Jemison, draws nothing but net.
13, his first NBA double-double in the win over the Pistons here last night. The big fella for three. Oubre knocks the rebound to Embiid. Joel leading the break.
Oh, my.
Behind the back.
Oh
back
my.
To him. What a fast break by your Philadelphia 76ers. And Kyle Lowry. Look at that fast break led by the big fella.
Magic Johnson comes to
mind.
And then the return pass. Kyle finding Joel still open underneath.
No look to Maxey. Tyrese weaving his way through the Grizzlies defense. Doesn't go. Joel gets the offensive rebound. And puts it back up and in. Oh, fans just behind us, Allah. They are literally sitting on our shoulders here in Memphis. And Allah's pretty funny. Another great block from Embiid. Second big rejection.
Watch him here. He turns this over and tries to flush it on JoJo.
No.
Joel able to get in between. Mm. Watch it one more time at the very last minute. And Joel got to put a stop to that.
Two-man game with Maxey and Embiid. Joel from the free throw line. That one goes through 30.
Watch JoJo on this last exchange. Him and Tyrese. Tyrese draws the defenders, and then the nice little pass fake. That opens up.
A real number for Brooklyn. Schroeder, leave it. Thomas trailing. He'll hoist. And hit. Cam Thomas from deep. Just under five to play in this opening quarter. Thomas dancing on Brown. Loses him on the step back. That is pretty. Cam Thomas.
Well, and I also believe that if you were 15, 16 years old coming up now, the way you would have trained would have been completely different. You know, even coming out of college, you shot threes. You shot threes and shot 40%.
And I remember the first time I ever did a five-out offense was with the Boston Celtics with Doc Rivers and, KG, Paul Pierce, Rondo. and, you know, a bunch of shooters as well.
Has reinvented his game. Here's Cam Thomas, who can just do a little bit of everything on all three levels. And,
I wish you, look, for the people listening on the radio at home.
Yeah, the ones that can see your luscious hair.
That's as long as they know.
Cam Thomas, he's starting to cook now. 8-0 Brooklyn run. Thomas up to 16.
But he is just a natural bucket getter. You get him the ball anywhere on the floor. Not only does he play in the trenches, he is undersized in those trenches against a lot of players. So you got to make sure, if you're not 100%, you got to make sure you protect yourself.
Finney Smith, nice job on the body control. And Finney Smith is on the board.
Detroit only shot two free throws there in that first half, so they did a good job of defending without fouling, and they have to maintain that.
Thomas wiggles in, and Claxton pushes it through.
That I love the most about the addition of his game, dropping dimes, those passes, and when one of your best players is putting forth that effort, that bodes well going into the fourth.
Thomas, Claxton was open for a moment. Instead, Clowney drains the three. So the 11-second difference, shot clock and game clock. Thomas on Boeheim, spins, fades, and scores.
And on the second end, Cam Thomas with the mini. Shooters like that, they're just at a premium in the NBA, mainly because they just force the floor to be open and to be spread.
Thomas, again, rattles it in.
You want to put the pressure on them early. Make them have to react.
Thomas, oh, he just gets it up in front of Wiseman for two. Around the horn it goes for Thomas. He's got Boeheim on him. They like the matchup. Instead, now he's got to go at Metu. Hangs and can't hit. Rebound inside Finney Smith. Thomas on the reload. His three. Money. And now he's late to recover defensively. It's a 5-on-4. Noel takes advantage. Comes up short. Thomas leaking out after that play. Gets the rim for the deuce.
Just in transition, Cam Thomas doesn't get back and makes him pay.
Schroeder gets a screen from Wilson. Switch there with Brown. Curling, Thomas floats it up.
Claxton, the Dark Knight rises. And this is what I'm talking about. Now you have the defense guessing if you're Cam Thomas. You're able to get into the lane. You're also able to feed your big man. This helps. And this is what I'm talking about. Now you have the defense guessing if you're Cam Thomas.
Much of a show that Jaren Jackson Jr. is putting on. Kate Cunningham doing the same for the Pistons.
Eight straight by Detroit. Jaren going to the cup. 36 for Jaren Jackson Jr. Grizzlies a 2-point lead and the leather, 2.5 remaining.
How about that extension by Jaren on that block?
Second block. And a finish by Jaren.
I'm watching the antics of TJ. Good fun. And TJ's over here doing the entire move that Decent has had.
And his Team USA teammate from the summer, Halliburton, got it.
Good basketball. Really good basketball.
Recognition early by Nimhart in the air, the ball coming through.
Your defense is solid. Watch Nimhart gets it, and right away he knows he can move it to the wide open Halliburton, who knocks down that three.
Siakam, Halliburton sets again for another three. Got it. 13 straight Pacers points.
Call the timeout.
Regain that 3-point shot. He got it from Siakam. Early on, 3.5 minutes in, 13-4. Schroeder off the Claxton screen. And that ball knocked away. Good defense by Siakam.
Oh, yeah. I mean, last minute. Just prior to taking the thinking he was going to take a shot, able to get it. Nice job. He reads it. In that fast break, you see Miles does the right thing. You can learn that as part of the Dallas Mavericks. And Rick Carlisle had great confidence in him.
Here's Halliburton off the glass, count it. He has a chance for a 3-point play. And just like that.
Watford didn't get a clean look. Keep it going.
Here's Halliburton, another three and another basket.
Yeah, he's had a heat check here to get a hand on it. Read it, wide open, in rhythm, bucket by Halliburton.
He has 14 first quarter points. Now tip to Halliburton.
Oh, Siakam has him. What a pass. What an assist. I mean, he throws the ball with only Siakam.
Tipped out by Turner to Halliburton. And yeah. Halliburton pounds it down. A yak, yak.
Way to find
yourself in position to push the ball back the other way. Halliburton takes a look. Little ball fake. Nobody stops him. Impressive.
We are back, and the Pacers have it again on a missed shot. Here's Siakam, and Halliburton lays it in.
Oh, he was going to dunk it at first and did a nice.
In Chicago on Friday, he made 7 from three-point range. Brooklyn, a season-high 25, and dunking at home is Smith.
And Halliburton gets another assist. I mean, just a nice job. Turning the corner, you see that the defense does not stop Halliburton. Might call a timeout. This is what I think he's going to let him work out a little bit.
Halliburton for 3. Perfect.
Yeah, listen, he could have painted the three-point line out there.
And these teams, what's interesting, they play again on Wednesday night in Brooklyn. Neesmith in the corner from Halliburton for 3.
With a great find.
5 of those games, he's been in double figures. And
the
here's
D,
the steal.
The
Halliburton pounds it down.
Anticipation. Coming off kind of a run and jump action. North Carolina used to do it. They would be normally a switch. The good hands, you see them enjoying it.
He's not even standing
not
up
yet.
No coach. Oh, Clifford is standing up. In that half court. Out of the coaching box, by the way.
It's Tatum on Williams. What do you think?
Chopping him up, dicing him up. At Oklahoma City, he just played like sparing minutes. But now he's getting a chance to actually come out here and hoop.
Came over in the Gordon Hayward trade. Tatum with a hand in the face, drops it in. Maybe a little subjective there.
Oh, so what can I ask? And how did he knock down the 3?
As he calls it, non-shooters making tough shots that they're okay giving up.
I just thought we lost our edge, and then something happened, and he said enough is enough already. Jason Tatum goes strong to the basket.
Defended by Trey Mann around the Brissett screen, probing down low. Hauser, no hesitation, counted.
Yeah, I can just tell the way that Charlotte was set up.
0-on-0 matchup. Tatum wins it, hit ahead for White. Right back to Tatum. The longest give and go in NBA history ends up with a Tatum 3.
He's clearly a good player. How do you find minutes for him with LaMelo Ball?
Maybe runs your second unit.
And you can play him and Ball off the ball.
Jason Tatum, a two-hand stop.
And I got no problem with it. I lived through that as a coach when I was with the Warriors, as Tatum goes baseline. Sweet move. People used to roll their eyes at Draymond Green. Oh!
Jason Tatum! Punishing the iron for the second time tonight.
They have all the other positions all shored up.
Tatum tees it up. It's a 3. He's just feeling it now on a Monday in Charlotte.
That guy?
A great guy. And he pointed out that Miles Bridges this year has played more games than LaMelo Ball has the last 2 years combined.
Oh, wow.
And Tatum just in control of this game from the jump. Sam Hauser on the tip-in.
And that's just great spacing.
Tatum draws 2, skips it. Hauser, 3-pointer, yes, sir!
And I think that would include Derek White on the dribble handoff. Yes, please give it to me.
Good call, Romo. Leads to a Hauser 3, and he knocks in another. Ended the third with a triple, and he starts the fourth with a triple. Oh, Hauser,
come
turn
on
and shoot.
Come
give it
on
to him. A tough one from Sam Hauser in the corner.
Listen, if Grant makes shots, he'll play. He's a wonderful player, and you know, but he's got to be able to make shots.
Hauser, all alone. Probably don't want to leave that guy. Hauser again. Again. Right down the hatch.
Incredible.
Exactly. That's kind of the point Missoula's been making the last week.
Yeah, you got to know what to react to and what not to react to.
5 on the timer. Tatum, dagger.
A little mini.
Not a lot of good size and length. 8-9-11. Harris skips it to Wagner for the nice reverse off the glass.
This is what the article said. I found the article, the original article from Miami, Oklahoma. It spread like wildfire. Franz Wagner, good for 3.
Nice.
Good for 3. Good to see. 46-44, 3:20 left in the quarter.
Wagner challenging Ayton, and that was pretty easy for Franz Wagner.
With their biggest lead of the game on an 8-2 run. Franz Wagner, screen from Carter. Back to him on the pick and roll. Perfectly executed.
Franz Wagner, here's this read. Watch number two, Ayton. As soon as he steps up, watch Franz. He knows where to get it to. You got two to the basket.
Harris. Wagner. Rupert guards him. Carter back to Franz. Into the body of Ayton. He puts it in.
Just too fast. Right off of Henderson's hands.
Wagner takes the inbound pass, scores. He's fouled. 3-point chance for Franz Wagner.
That's Jalen Suggs on this curl. Gives it to him. Perfect timing on that.
DeRozan's at 27 or more points in 5 straight games. 11 so far in this one. Bogey. Beauty.
Oh, man.
Short clock here for the Hawks. Bogdanovich looking at Kobe White. He'll drive, gets inside and lays it in.
Well, that was Vucevic's fault. He gave up on the play. Really did a good job of helping.
Off Jalen's fingertips, recovers. 7 on the shot clock. Bulls trying to pick it up defensively. Deflected to Bogey. He'll take the long one and nail it. What a three by Bogey. My goodness.
Well, that one was from Georgia. He pulled up from there. I mean, it didn't even touch the rim.
Bruno, quick handoff to Bogey, controls the dribble, throws up the runner off the glass. Hawks shooting it so well. Working off the Bruno screen. Shot clock down to 6. Bogey hits the mid-ranger. Bogey to Murray. Gets around Caruso. Back to Bogey. Change of direction. Ball fake. Laying good.
And right on cue. Right on cue.
5 seconds between the shot clock and the game clock. Anthony. Mancaro. He'll take the three. He got it. On the drive again. Nice. That's easy against Jones.
It was on his hip.
I don't think it would be reversed because of that. Carter, Vancaro. Drives in against Daniels. Floater is good.
Coach Mosley talking, part of those magic standards is not fouling. Oh,
goodness gracious, Vancaro. One end of the floor to the other. And a holding foul on Gary Harris away from the ball is going to give Murphy 2 free throws.
Look at that, Paolo, with that nice, watch him on the Euro step, and then nobody on the weak side. Zion wasn't coming over.
Wagner, what a pass. Ben Caro, the easy throwdown. Let's go back to the first half for tonight's Honda assist. Hans Wagner. They only had 5 second chance points in Orlando against the Magic.
Remember the other night against Portland. That was an issue. Gave them too many second chance opportunities. Paolo.
2 free throws cut the lead to 4.
He could score at every level.
Yep. And Caro against the zone. Backs out. 15-foot jumper. It's good. Orlando ball. Bancaro. Spins in there against Dyson Daniels. Paolo up top. Takes another 3. He drills it. That's no good. Big rebound, Carter. Throws it ahead to Harris. Only 10 seconds left. Bancaro puts the icing on the cake for the Magic.
Let's go home!
Edwards. Deep in the corner. They're calling it a 3. We'll check the toes.
Let's have a look at Edwards' 3. That's his first
two fouls. And he thought he got fouls. Shot.
I mean, so like, I watched the 9 field goals that he's made this year, and I told you, 6 of them were dunks, so it wasn't very complicated. The other 3 were kind of layups around the rim.
First ISO bucket of the game for Minnesota. And we've talked about this before, the benefit of having the guy that no matter what position you put him in. Here's Edwards. Sidesteps into a 3 ball and connects.
A rotational player for them and did a nice job.
Well, step back, Edwards. Oh, so good.
Minnesota's bench outscoring, getting outscored right now by Toronto.
Edwards fires and hits. Quickly slow to get back in the play. Now back on your screen. Edwards, the runner, guides it home.
Ant's just looking to get into a rhythm right now.
He was out of the NBA this morning. He signed a 10-day contract.
All right.
0 for 6.
17-38 against Toronto in the history of this franchise. That's the lowest of any opponent in the NBA as Nikhil Alexander-Walker knocks down the corner three.
That was game number one of the NBA season. Both teams entered that game after having an undefeated preseason. Nas Reed for three. Count it. Edwards driving on McDaniels, takes the bump and got the bounce. Another board in a crowd. Edwards, under 10 on the shot clock, fires a tray, swish.
That's a little bit of a microcosm.
Williams getting back. I like this reaction after the three from Anthony Edwards. This is the second night of a back-to-back. You mentioned Toronto dominating the all-time series, even here in Minnesota. There's Edwards. Nice turnaround for two.
And that would be Pascal Siakam.
I think they would have. They certainly would be more formidable, but
Edwards, you know,
they're doing
for
what,
three.
Yeah, they're doing what they're doing in their best interest. Those players they moved were not going to.
Holmgren switching out on him. There's the mismatch for Porzingis. Shot clock down to two. Got to get busy. Tough move. Year, right? Brown sprays it out to Porzingis for three. Hits that Porzingis at 36 for Boston ball.
Porzingis, you see here, Holmgren goes to help, leaving
Holiday on the short roll, sprays it out to Tatum. Porzingis for three, same result. How hard is that, JJ? For a guy like Holiday.
He's coming off an all-star season when he was the primary ball handler on the number one seed.
And here comes Holiday. They've got numbers, 5-on-4. One more to a wide open Horford, shooting well over four. Oh, what a follow by Porzingis.
Showing the depth of his game here with the offensive rebound.
Run a little empty corner two-man game, and Porzingis got the switch, JJ. The help came, but it didn't matter. Porzingis with a mismatch. Light work. Really light work. 14 in the game.
He's a good basketball player.
Remember last year when there were rumblings about him wanting to be traded because he wanted to be a part of the rotation? Well, they rewarded him with a nice contract during the offseason, and he's rewarding them. Pritchard out to Hauser. Brown the trailer. Spins on Giddy. Pristine passing. Cash out.
Dunk. And then defensively, one of the best rim protectors in the NBA. And this is where he really excels. Spacing the floor, knocking down three.
Wiggins with the crossover on Hauser. Couldn't get it to go in traffic. No call. Porzingis with the left hand, sweet move off the rim. Porzingis with 21. Dort on Porzingis, light work again by Kristaps Porzingis, 23 in the ball game.
Again, one way to beat a zone is to get the ball to the middle of the floor. And when that player that has the ball is 7'3", chances are
just 2 points in the game. Porzingis as the shorter defender. Boy, rerun and remix it. Porzingis again with 25. OKC trying to stop the hemorrhaging here. Wiggins out front. Nice slip by Williams. By Porzingis. Off the Williams screen. And White just peeled him clean. They've got numbers.
Well, Derek White has had a
quiet night offensively, but always making an impact. Gets the steal. How about your 7'3" center running the break?
Across to Wiggins. Drives it into the lane. Tried to take a body and got put in the friend zone by Porzingis. That's his fifth block. Brown from deep. Butter.
Him of how Anthony was when he first came into the league, looking for that opportunity. His temperament. Scoot knocking down a three, going right at him.
Scoot Henderson, checked by Mann, off the screen of Ayton, leans in for Teardrop. Delano's been on fire. Little ball fake, drives it in on Miller, kicks to Rupier. Scoot sets it up for Ayton, and he drilled it.
Looked like Scoot wanted to go all the way behind the back with the wraparound first. Led the entire game in that last loss versus Orlando. He had 9 assists in that one. Was hoping to make a 10 with the game winner. And here, he's got the jumper going early. The plays he's making off of the dribble, the passes. He's making passes where he's not putting two hands on the ball. And it's the right plays. Usually, Scoot's got the jumper flowing tonight.
Just, you know, resurrecting the franchise, but he's not Damian Lillard. He's not a top 75 guy all the time. So LaMelo Ball coming into this situation.
I don't remember the deal that sent him from OKC out of there, but were you surprised that Oklahoma City let him go?
Tonight he is, but when he's not feeling downtown and DeAndre Ayton, a baseline, you never really see the baseline two-point jumper.
And Henderson will bring it out of backcourt. Blazers up 3, 5 minutes gone by here in the third. Walker fires a pillow, a three-pointer for Jabari, who's at 28% on the year.
Like, they have to force the issue where those are the only two options for Charlotte.
There we go. That three is just looking so sharp tonight. Scoot. Chauncey wants him to slow it up. Scoot with a jog along the edge. Now a burst coming off the screen into a teardrop. Flings it up and in.
There it is. Scoot came off. Grant Williams, he's back.
To defend Scoot Henderson. Let's see what they do with this. Now Pokuševski will switch on it with 4, with 3, with 2. Gets rid of the shot with 1. Got it! Oh, a dagger. 109 left in the ballgame.
Philly has spent a little bit of time here with the Nets recently. Of course, we know Keon Johnson did as well. Congrats to the Long Island Nets.
Schroeder gives it up. Clowney, the short hop goes down.
The ability for Indiana to create quality looks over and over again that has benefited.
Freddie Smith drives in. Clowney got a 3. It's Oregon also. I don't know if you've ever said Oregon.
I have not.
No, it's Oregon.
Oregon, I knew. Oregon, yeah.
Clowney, another 3. Back-to-back for the rookie Noah Clowney. Schroeder drives in around Siakam, former teammates. Clowney there to finish. Beautiful setup by Dennis Schroeder. Nets are down by 1, under 2 minutes to go, first half. Halliburton drives in. Blocked by Clowney. He erased it.
He liked this by Noah Clowney. Big time block on how skill set he brings to the table. Compete level.
Schroeder, corner. Clowney's on a heater. Death. Bridges drive. Kick outside. Finney Smith can't hit the 3. Clowney working hard. Clowney lays it in. Of really impressive things tonight.
And doing it all. Look at him working on the inside. He's so quick and light off his feet with his second jump.
Jalen Wilson getting ready to check in. That's up 84-76. Under 3 minutes to go in the third. Johnson attacks, dishes, Clowney hammers it down.
Here are the Knicks now. They lost by 10 in Miami on Tuesday. Cutting inside. Johnson. The contact, got it to drop in a foul.
Passer. He's known as a rebounder, but a very skilled guy passing the ball.
Pretty shot inside. Ellis was defending, and Brunson. So the Knicks have lost 3 consecutive games, their longest since the All-Star break. Cut inside, double pumps.
15th in the league in three-point percentage. Had 2 great looks there. And Sacramento's been great in transition, but they are being aggressive against Brunson.
Hart takes it in for 2. Working on Ellis, going underneath, tried to sneak it in. Picked up by Mitchell, who put his fingerprints on it. It's Brunson, the fake, the drive, and the floater on the floor.
Wow, that's Brunson's so great when he gets in the paint. Sabonis already with 5 assists 9 minutes into the game.
Here comes Hart, who drives inside hard and gets it to go. He is
already halfway to the 91 points they had out there, and we're only 16 minutes into the game.
And nice play. Brunson inside, gets it to go. He finagles his way for two. Hartenstein up top, and Lynn is on him. Shot clock at 7. Inside, Hartenstein, and a Hart. He collides inside with Ellis.
Another outstanding pass by Hartenstein and Josh Hart. Sacramento winning doubled. If the ball moves to the weak side, other guys on Knicks are going to have opportunities.
Sabonis knocked away, stolen by Brunson. From behind, Mitchell. Brunson. So a steal right here. And the Knicks, a top 10 defensive team, coming up with two on the transition. Hartenstein inside to Brunson. Mitchell is on him. Shot clock at 4. Beautiful 15-footer. Silky smooth shot. And off the bench, Mitchell has put in 11. He averages 5 at the other end. Hart. Foul. Count it. Lyles went down. Hart was driving.
Hart is a great finisher, especially in transition with a head of steam.
The Knicks are shooting 46%, 65% shooting for the Kings. Brunson on the wing, and this is a shot over Mitchell. Good! Big three needed. The Knicks at 44-31, same record for the Kings. But the Knicks, number 5 in the East. Down low, positioning, beautiful shot. Jalen Brunson puts it in. He's caught fire with 8 points here in the third. Brunson fakes the pass and takes it in. Lyles will meet him. Then a try, knifing in. Hart. Pretty play, and Hart's down. Scoop pass, Brunson. Scoop pass, Hartenstein. There's the basket by Hart. With Brunson getting the hockey.
We keep talking tonight about Josh Hart's ability to finish around the rim. Here he goes to the other side of the basket and scores, putting together another outstanding game.
The Knicks have either led or were tied with less than 4 minutes to go in each of those games. Inside, Brunson knocked it away with the deflection. DiVincenzo ahead to Hart. Chris, thank you. You broke some new information on that. Here goes Hart down low, and he spins there on the defense of Vezenkov. And 20 points for Hart. And a rebound by Josh Hart. Down the middle, right through the defense, goes Hart! Woo! Out 3 months, came back, tweaked it. Now he's back again. And it sounds like Randall did the same thing. Hartenstein has it, bumped by Sabonis. Feeding to Brunson, leaning, firing, got it! Got it to go, 24 for him.
Just plays off 2 feet so well in the paint.
Brunson, shot clock is at 9. He's picked up by Mitchell, he threads the pass to Hart, who climbs into Sabonis! A 7-0 run by the Knicks. Count it with a foul on the play.
In the second half, he knows they're going to blitz every pick and roll, so instead of bringing his center up, he brings Hart up. This time they switch it. Now they come back and double, but not quick enough. And Brunson knocks down a 3.
ABA merger with this long shot by Brunson.
Brunson again able to go one-on-one, and he operates from the top. And Ellis playing him very physically, but Brunson able to finish through the contact. Harrison Barnes has been invisible tonight. 16 points when these teams played the last time. Has not scored tonight.
Brunson again connects mid-range.
R, and they have not disappointed at all tonight.
It's Hart inside. This is over Sabonis. Attacking the lane, the guards doing the damage for the Knicks. On the wing is Hartenstein, and Sabonis right with him with under 3 to go. A spinning Hart. Got it in, twirls for 2. 9 consecutive made baskets for the New York shot. Rebound Hart. Here comes Brunson right into the defense of Ellis.
Ball ball after the miss by Jalen Johnson. In transition, Kyrie accelerates against Bogdanović. The Rams are kind that time as Kyrie Irving goes right at the defense and scores.
Kyrie recognizing, not getting back, has the angle. Uses the contact to drift a little bit.
Nearly 40% for the year. Quick trigger three, no good. Boomerangs right back to Kyrie Irving. Now a shorter corner three-point attempt that he connects.
But made vast improvements since his last year.
Almost 11 points per game better this year than last year. Kyrie stops on a dime, pulls up, rattles it home. But off target on the shot attempts. Defensive board claimed by Gafford. Luka, drop buster!
Will the floodgate open?
Now, Luka. Oh, Beat Krejci is having a hard time, and so hard of a time that he got caught in no man's land.
Anytime he creates space, if you're not diligent about keeping that space, he's going to take it up.
He shot 57.5% on threes in his last seven games. And guys, he's making a run to qualify for the league leaders in three-point percentage and perhaps the league lead. By the way, speaking of a guy now, one of the Suns. Jalen Johnson, big block by Kleba. He rejects it to Duncanville. Here's a shot fake and drive, and slicing through the defense, Luka Doncic. Pella missed a chippy. Goodness. And there's that hard pull three. And a free throw.
You just have to respect his drive so much. Just a little bit of a...
Capella. Man, Kleba really digging in and holding his ground there to defend.
Oh, nice outlet.
And there's QB1! Tim Hardaway Jr. catches the long pass.
It's good.
And assist passes of more than 50 feet. And how about that for on time, on target?
Able to walk them down and able to get a win. So it's a team that you're going to have to put away and really put a stamp on it.
Kyrie inside with the basket for the Mavs to tie it. After Atlanta had scored five straight out of a tie of 17, the Mavs are holding opponents since the trades on back in February to 53.5% shooting in the paint. And there is a smooth turnaround midi to let Kyrie Irving.
Absolutely. You know, just, all right. You know, give me some space. Give me a nice little bump and a nice.
Not even that great of a time.
Here's Luka along the sideline. And hello, Winda! Another display of some Luka magic. It's when it comes to Luka Doncic. He didn't score.
He's now 1-7 tonight.
This third quarter, as Kyrie operates, it's where he's been cooking, and he got right where he wanted to go, Caldwell.
Yeah, the chef is cooking some more as he was going up the chute. Bogdanović, he's made two baskets here in the quarter. Deflection, Luka. Save it, Luka!
Wow.
The leading scorer in the league doing that, and here's Blake 55! Mike Jones. Rebounding is Dallas, one to the good. Luka! Bogdanović up on Luka. Late clock. We know what Luka does in these situations. That is what he does. Krejci up on Luka. Put it down once. Step back, Jack. Game. They have committed 15 in all tonight. And we still have over 13 minutes to play. Nice catch by Kyrie. Came down, goes to Ward with the foul. Kyrie Irving to Picasso of the paint.
Catches it one hand, and then a double clutch.
Down by 30 and storming back. Kyrie walks into a long three and a big hit.
Kyrie looked up and said, I'm that open, huh? I'll just bomb away.
We're talking about somebody who's only played like a little over 110 minutes this season. And he's got some tough work to do here. I mean, the other Kobe didn't stop Kyrie Irving very many times.
No.
Pulls it back. Reggie Jackson picks him up. And George just going to take on himself. A little fadeaway is good for Paul George.
against the Kings. Great pass by Jokic. Brown comes up short. They need Brown to keep shooting, though. George, wow. Wow, George put the brakes down. Denver needs their big five back.
Yeah, they will. Arguably the best starting five in the game.
Nuggets and the Celtics just seize the game so well. Just follows the flow of the game as Paul George rips a three. Hand, knee, whatever. And he's trying to play through it. That's one thing. Head injuries, though, make you a little concerned. But apparently, he's okay as George, despite a Jokic triple-double in that game. That was here in Los Angeles. Paul George rises up, knocks it down. Harden gets stuck. George with KCP on him. Big screen by Zubac. Paul George.
And he's getting absolutely...
George feeling it right now. Keeps his dribble. Gets by Porter. Second time he's put that move on Michael Porter Jr.
With the stars right here. Series of moves and just goes absolutely right at the chest.
This is Watson on George. George barrels in. George lays it in. Caldwell Pope with 13. George up and over Watson. Wow, that was a spectacular shot.
Last five averaging 19, and they'll look for him to score more with Gilgeous Alexander out. Here's a three in the corner. It's good by Nesmith.
Yeah, pass from Siakam.
You got the matchup you want. He did his back screen, and they got Dort guarding him.
Siakam over the top. Got it.
I mean, he just is so good at that. And what I believe, the little guys are so good. He's popping twice. The little guys are really good. Now the bigs can make jump shots, and now they're putting it on the floor. Miles Siakam off to the great early start, gets a good pass, gets bumped there, and then slapped on the arm and able to get...
He's their second leading scorer, nearly 20 points per game, missing another game his third straight with an ankle sprain, and the Pacers get the three. It's Pascal Siakam. Now Siakam against Kendrick Williams. Fades and scores. Pacers fans. Smith had 12 points and 6 rebounds in the first 24 minutes. Out front, Siakam against Kenrich Williams. Ball spun to the basket and score.
He did a really nice job of being strong with the ball.
Now to Wiggins for three. Oh, yeah. Nesmith the rebound. Pushed ahead to Toppin. Here's Siakam, throws it down.
Good advance of the basketball, put the pressure.
Put your hands on.
Really love how he... I must have missed that. Oh, someone's living right.
Richard, though he's been living good, when you get bounces like this.
Kick to the corner by Porzingis, and the three is knocked down. Porzingis, right spot, kicks it out, corner jumper, goes.
Porzingis is a factor in the game.
Yeah, that's a different play, and Pritchard comes over to steal. Gets it to Hauser to the basket. No, it's a pass.
Pass deflected, picked off Pritchard, set on the shot clock. Peyton takes it. Makes it a big shot. Under 8 to play. Nice move off the dribble by Pritchard. Takes the shot. All right, Pritchard at the top of the key. Here he goes. There's a little stop and pop.
Hezenkov picks up the foul.
Peyton. Well, you better not leave him.
Inside.
Better not leave him. You don't want to double off of him.
Mamu brings it back. Rolls. And scores.
I love that combination right there. 5-4 screaming.
8 on the shot clock. Victor turns against Daniels. Shovels it underneath. And Branham gets the reverse layup.
Oh, what a play, though. Instead of going into
Spurs, Rose will slap it away.
Victor off to Champagne. Back to Vic. Wants the three and nails it.
There you go. Like I said, they've gotten away with it.
All I'll say to that is don't get cocky. Wemby knocks that one in and then took a shot to the eye. Victor, 7 points, seven boards, seven assists. Fires the three. Got it. He's warming up.
Yes, he is.
Didn't make a field goal. And again, his high-arching layup attempt. Back, Wemby inside to Mamu. Hit a spot.
Bringing the ball up the floor and then puts the pass right on the money where only Mamu can get it.
Great body. Back to Victor. Some patience here. He's got McCollum guarding him, and that is a no contest. Yeah, and Champagne finds it.
That was a good no whistle because, wait, that move. Don't do anything crazy with it.
Victor, how about that crazy? That's just good basketball.
Yeah, Victor, we know come fourth quarter, he just seems to get his legs underneath him. He's got
switch now. Pelicans down one, trying to grab the lead. Jones in the pick block by Wemby. They got a foul. They do. Graham. I mean, fouled it.
Marcus Sasser with a long gun. It is off the heel. Brown Jr. with a rebound. Jaden Ivey for three, and that one's through. Troy Brown Jr. had a deep bounce, and he bet it inside to a woman in the corner to Jaden Ivey. Another triple right down the middle. Jaden, stop and go to the rim, lays it up, lays it in. And the Pistons have a two-point lead on the Grizzlies. Make it 9-8 Grizzlies. Marcus Sasser cross-courts to Jaden Ivey. Nice screen from Jalen Duren. Another three is through. Dribble hands off to Jaden Ivey. Whips it to Aroma. Baseline to Brown Jr. Topside Jaden, another long gun. This one is in and out and back in again. It's 36-28 Memphis. 8:50 to play in the first half. Noel back to Jaden for the long gun. It goes. Another splash down three for Jaden Ivey.
He's just shooting 50% from the three-point, from the free throw line in his last five games.
Maybe just a hiccup. Here is Noel to the baseline. Short gun goes for Jalen Noel. 53-33 Memphis. Jalen Duren. Top side of Jaden Ivey. Inside to Jalen. Hoops and scores it off the square.
And it all gives them a chance to get back and set up defensively because the Pistons are having to take the ball out of bounds.
Jaden gets to the basket. 66-42. Jaden Ivey stops and fires. Fills it. Got no rim whatsoever. And when you got it going, you got it going.
Good one.
Here's Jaden Ivey proving that as he gets to the rack, lays it up, lays it in. D.G. Jackson with 10 on the clock. Launches a long, long three. That's short to Jalen Duren. Pistons are 5-on-4. Open, Jaden Ivey, and he connects. Another long gun goes for Jaden.
Swings it out to Terry Rozier. Bam from the elbow. That's good. Bam Adebayo coming off a 14.
Wonderful player there that they really counted on in Minnesota.
And the Heat still counting on him in a different way. He's such a valuable player to have on your team. Bam Adebayo hits the short shot to open the second quarter. 1-point Rockets with him. They have five first half trades. Heat with just one. A free one for Bam.
Really?
Two Rockets. Bam has a fight hard for his fifth rebound of the half. Coming right at Jeff Green. Oh, coming right at the NBA's version of a senior
citizen. Guy who had to come in and prove and earn everything that he's got.
Oh, Bam with a slam. How about Bam Adebayo?
Well, here's the assist right here. Tyler finding with the pocket pass bounce, and that's a two-hand.
Rozier, a spinner on the baseline. Bam to the offensive board and the put-back hook. 16 to defense, and then losing it to Dylan Brooks. Here comes Brooks, coming right at Bam. Oh, he pinned it. He pinned it. Watching for Adebayo.
Look at the timing. Oh, that is spectacular. Still on the way up. It did touch the backboard first, and he just
Bam against Jabari Smith Jr. For the Cunningham Smith, slams it through. Now you put two on Bam, he's going to find the open man.
Yeah, really.
4.5 minutes left. Pretty baseline jump shot for Bam Adebayo. His 18th point.
5 of 16 to begin the night is New York. Osumu underneath. Ah!
On the baseline, baby, plays the baseline like John McEnroe.
And now with 9.
Wolves have had a couple of turnovers.
Javonte Green! Oh,
go get it, Javonte Green!
Going to the Ric Flair drip, hit him. Woo! There it is. Oh. Using that body. Green tips it alive to Caruso. Green
numbers.
On 2. Caruso to Dosumu in the corner. Green's got a nice half. Bulls reset. DeRozan drives. Ball fake. What a pass. All day, Javonte Green.
Bang, 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 JG.
You can tell it's frustrating him. We've seen it happen to DeRozan at times this year. Good turnaround for DeRozan. What a tip in by Javonte Green.
Oh, my goodness.
Good job by Vucevic to box out Hartenstein. And Osumu missed it. Javonte Green flies in.
Javonte Green tied his career high with 9 rebounds.
Vucevic.
He got turned it down.
And Javonte Green with 21 points now. Number 31 for the Knicks. DeRozan. Oh! Green's got the rebound.
Turned down for 118.
Personalities clashing a bit because you're not playing that bad. Like, you're not that bad offensively, which this is an offensive lead. And I'm sorry, Gary Trent Jr. with the floater.
Kelly. Gary triggers it. Collects. And the Raptors trail by 5.
It leaves a free run for Lopez to get that offensive board.
Gary turns, fires 3. Good. Got 10 of his 12 here in the quarter. 2-point game once again. Can the Raptors get a stop? Tie it or take the lead? Gary with the steal. Gary to the bucket, the one-handed slam, and we're tied at 51.
Quickly with your little Steve Lash impersonation. Good offense. Good defense again by the Raps.
Raptors get another stop. Gary to the trailing quickly. Back to Gary, corner 3. Book it in a timeout, Doc Rivers.
Out of the timeout. Great defense.
Here's quickly a burst of speed. Gary the 3. Book it.
Lillard likes to do. I will not switch many other players on him right now while he's in the game.
Quickly over to Gary. Sidestep 3.
Swinging the ball.
Hop step, Gary, in traffic.
Tough move.
Milwaukee by 1. Lillard has 30. Gary 3. Raptors.
I love the composure by Quigley.
Kelly falling. Here's Gary 3. Good. Raptors back up on top. And Trent Jr., 7 for 15 from 3 for 31.
Backdoor cut by Durant on a little baseline fade, and they'll get the and one opportunity. Reed a step late. Conley did not play in their last game. Another good defensive stand is Nurk with a steal up ahead to Beal, and Beal brings the boom. Durant with 5 on the shot clock, has to go. Leans back on McDaniels. Minnesota in the paint, guys. Minnesota comes in averaging almost 51 points per game in the paint. The Suns have harassed them into 2 of 9 shooting as KD connects.
I love that play.
So jumper.
He's getting hot.
39% from beyond the arc at 14. Suns coming right back with an answer of their own, though.
I mean, nobody's going to block his shot.
Alexander Walker, too strong with the left hand. Durant clears. Suns in transition, up ahead to Poole, who makes a rim run. Six on the shot clock. Nurkic on the roll. Swings a pass to an open shooter. That would be Kevin Durant. Pass over the top is Connolly trying to stay attached to Durant. And that is not a battle he is likely to win. Had 10 in the victory on Wednesday. Book gets a clear look from downtown. Won't get it. Allen with a back tap. Recovered by Durant. Scoop feed to Nurkic. Booker gets it to the baseline. Look for Durant. Finally.
I like the substitution, though, getting them out here.
KD will take that free throw line extended jumper at a much-needed knockdown field goal from Durant. Eubanks passing that one up. Takes the pocket pass. Able to gather it up quickly before the defender got there.
Tells you how good their defense was last night.
When you go back to that big streak where they were 26-5, they found a variety of ways, and they didn't do anything that wasn't repetitive.
Speaking of math, Brian, I was thinking about this earlier. If you, and maybe this makes it simpler for Clipper fans. They just have to go 4-2 as Harden knocks down another three.
Sense of ball control. They raved about his passing. He takes it to the rim but can't get it to go. Man behind the defense.
Terrence Mann out ahead. Harden more than willing to throw that lead pass when guys are running in.
26-10.
Another lead pass.
Zoo lays it up and in. You mentioned Utah, not a very big team. Clippers taking advantage of it right there.
If you're another player, you love playing with James Harden for that reason. He is going to reward you. NBA players so good at that. It's stripping guys low. You know you're not going to block it high. So make, even if you don't get a piece of the ball, make him change his route as Harden knocks down the three. Change their route so that they miss the shot.
James, by the way, has only taken three shots. He's made them all. Harden has taken four shots.
But if you let him get his ISO game going end of clock, he's going to knock that down. Terrence Mann finishing at the rim. So athletic, sexy at his size to go up and get that offensive rebound.
Powell for three. The pinky feels fine. 75-37. I get it. The Clippers still are up. I'd like to see James Harden go to the bench.
Oh,
my goodness. Russell Westbrook continuing to defy gravity in his 30s. Clippers out in front, 108-81.
12:30 Sunday against the Cavs. You know, if this was a design play or not, or it was just a read by Westbrook, but Harden saw him cut into the rim. Put it up there perfectly for the contact to get to the line, but didn't get the whistle.
Heist behind the defense, lays it up and in. 110-83.
Guess what? Another lead pass from Harden.
Those days are gone.
Well, the minute they started this play-in tournament, things changed. And I think it's been such a success, for to your point.
No team has held an opponent under 100 points more than them. Rozier rings up a triple. Terry Rozier bombs away for him. He's got a few Nick offensive rebounds of the quarter. They couldn't capitalize. Rozier on a keeper for three. Kaboom! Right choice for Scary Terry. DiVincenzo is down in the front court. He's okay, though. In the corner, it's Rozier. Here it comes. Kaboom! And a foul!
Well around the perimeter. Caleb skipping it across and gets Terry a good look in that comfy corner.
How about Terry Rozier, John? 3 out of 4 from downtown. He's got a chance at a four-point play. Inside Butler. Collides with Achiuwa. Rozier for three. Yes. Fourth triple of the first half for Terry Rozier. Three on it. We'll see if that stands. Right now, McBride with 15 points. Miami up 10. Rozier again. Terry Rozier, one kaboom.
Look at the left hand. He loves this pullback move here where he can set his feet, create some space. Dante DiVincenzo.
Robinson, now Rozier, guarded tightly by McBride. Three on the shot clock for Robinson. Rozier fading left. Got it anyway. That kind of night for Terry Rozier. He is 6 for 7. McBride averages 8 points per game.
He's really filled in well with Brunson, not his typical scoring self. McBride has been good.
Terry Rozier, you know he's doing right now. He's feeling himself.
Creation, his ability off the dribble and the sidestep here again. Look at the beautiful footwork. I mentioned him love going.
Seven starts, he's doing it again. Heat ahead by 11. Rozier against McBride. With under 4 minutes left in the third. Step back three. Yes! Terry Rozier continues his three-point barrage.
Footwork again by Terry Rozier. It's going to be a sidestep instead of left. He's going right. He's got some versatility, that man, to create openings for his shot.
Shot clock at five. This is going to be tough. Rozier, a contested three. Got it! Oh, my! Miraculous shot, a three for number two.
Struggling in the previous 9 or 10 games, I want to say, from beyond the arc. And little crushed legs and some rehab and recovery.
Oh, look at the finish.
You know, the NBA adjusted the rules, and now we don't have that problem.
Yep, you're right about that. There's Davion. Nice little pass to Domas with the finish. The bonus, that's it.
Because they've started knocking down those threes.
See if the Kings can get a bucket. Domas, nice quick move. How important is Domas in terms of going quickly sometimes on the offensive end? Domas, another rebound, his 12. Here come the Kings, looking to push the pace. HB, corner three, no. Oh, nice touch pass. That's how you find the big fella in Domantas Sabonis.
It's been super consistent for them in this game. 3 of 4 from downtown.
Yes, 17 points now for Norman Powell. Domas, that foul line jumper. It's going to be there, Katie. And once again, decisive with that, just the seventh turnover for the Kings. Oh, Powell got caught up. It's sloppy right now. Murray, oh! He got him! Next whistle. Here's Davion. Oh, getting to the paint. Nice find on the inside. Domas doing his Moses Malone impersonation. Sabonis, yes, his 15th rebound. Murray snaking that baseline. Nice little two-man game. And the Kings are just working over this Clippers defense. Look at this. 3 games.
Yeah, it's been one of those situations for him where he kind of had started playing more post All-Star break, as well as PJ Tucker.
Change. Domas just no. But Trey Lyles, he has been everywhere tonight. Look at that. Domas, another rebound. And Katie, you talked about the offensive glass. Quality big, no doubt. Barnes, clock at zero, no. Domas, yes. He is just a 22.
Three. Going in Brooks, and it bounces through. Nearly stripped, got it back, finds Morris. Now it's Reed on the baseline. 6 on the shot clock. Nas Reed, left hand. The 27. Nas Reed, left hand off glass.
Rudy can switch and cover.
Reed on the attack again. Another bucket. Three over to J-Mac. Three ball, corner pocket. Timeout Houston. In this second quarter by Minnesota, after only scoring 16 in the first period. Great hands by Anderson in the hands of Thompson, who's blocked.
J-Mac to Nas.
Three, cash. Edwards over to J-Mac again. Off the heel, rebound slow-mo, into Reed off glass for 2. Reed wants 3, got it!
he has put together 14 in the game for him.
Nas Reed to the cup. A 22-point night. Reed, the answer. Cash! Break opportunity for the Wolves, and Reed gives it up. Here's Edwards down the lane. The hammer! Look out below!
It's Exum, who's been scoring well, careening off bodies, lost it inside. Jackson Davis got it. Curry looking runways, pulling the air!
Offensively for the Warriors, and you can see the difference. The defense doesn't allow for Golden State to get anything easier. Boy, they needed that from Wiggins. Always want some size on him, especially when he's got to initiate a lot of the offense.
Wiggins worked around a couple of swiping Mavericks. He'll go the other way, Wizen for the Golden State Warriors. Green in the middle, spins Wiggins three. Here come the Warriors, a game below 500 at home, but six games overall above 500 on the season. Wiggins finagling his way for two, but gets the rebound and taken away by Looney. Lajemski, Wiggins on the side, into Exum. Lajemski will put it in play, driving and feeding. It's Wiggins on the baseline. The winner will go.
Laser one inside to Mobley. Mobley works on a shorter man in Sexton. Outside it goes to LeVert. LeVert drives, stops, fires, and scores as Caris LeVert ties this game at two. Mobley sends one inside to Jared Allen, and Allen lays it in to give the Cavaliers a 4-2 lead.
Jared Allen just under the basket. Nice hands, good pass.
There's Caris LeVert with a steal as LeVert knocks it away. He'll alley-oop for Allen, and Allen crushes it home to give the Cavaliers a 6-2 lead.
Bread and butter this basketball team is defending. Caris LeVert is excellent into passing lanes. Not scoring points, it's defending and stopping.
6-4 Cavaliers, 2 minutes in. Evan Mobley burrows his way inside and gives the Cavaliers an 8-4 advantage. We'll find Kessler. Now it's Colin Sexton, who was picked by the Cavs 8th overall back in 2018. You know where Colin's going. That's right to the basket. Evan Mobley, however, says no as he swats that Sexton shot.
Great defensive play. You know Colin's going to attack. Evan Mobley throws that stuff out of there.
Collins, he has had 18 and a 127-106 loss to the Kings. It was a lot more competitive than the score indicated as Mobley tests his range and Evan Mobley knocks it down. Mobley finds an alley. He'll dump off to Allen. Allen got Kessler in the air. He'll sneak it off the window and in. And Will Hardy wants an early first quarter timeout. Here come the Cavs in transition. Garland has his head up. Mobley just ran the whole way. Garland took his time, hesitated, allowed the big man to get there. Sacramento 2 nights ago, the most he has ever hit in his career is once again out. Free reign down the middle. The Cavs have been drawing Kessler, Brad, out of that middle. Shots. The Jazz have connected on 7 of their first 10. It's been a concern for the Cavs as Mobley works toward the basket. He lays it in through contact, and Mobley has a chance for the three-point play. I'm thinking about GM Justin Zanuck here in Utah. He fights through some physical issues as here goes Caris LeVert to the basket right through Kyra Lewis.
The Cavaliers are doing a great job. Everything's downhill going to the basket. So you're going hard, playing well, and you're going to get fouls. If you're
Jordan Clarkson is still one of the premier bench scorers in the NBA.
Light it up.
Allen inside once again. What a start for Allen. He's a perfect 5-for-5. Garland had 3 of them. He'll find Strus in the corner. Finds the cutter. Barrel to the basket. Missed the shot. Allen plucks it away from Yurtseven and puts it up and in. Put this thing to bed early, but credit the Jazz. After the Cavs got up to a really nice start, the Cavs outscored the Jazz 40-25. Allen to the basket. That's what the Cavs are looking for to reestablish that big man game.
Beautiful basketball.
They hit the ball into the face of Sexton. Now it's LeVert. Inside to Mobley. Now to Allen. Puts it up. That's blocked by Yurtseven. Mobley gets it back. He floats. No, but Allen is there to crush it home. Mobley. Hands to Strus. Strus to the top of the key. Over the top to Mobley. And the Cavs make it look easy.
Cavs got to take advantage of it. We're a bigger basketball team, more experienced team by just a little bit. Got to play that one.
Yurtseven puts it up. That's rejected by Mobley. Certainly happy to have Sam aboard. He's a DH and an outfielder. As Mobley to the basket. Mobley gets the roll. And man, after your own heart, he lettered in golf as well. But eventually it's Strus who squeezes it. Here's LeVert on the move. LeVert goes across the lane, finds the trailer, and Mobley thumps it home.
Wow.
Is spotlighted in our Duncan reward of
the game.
That is absolutely fantastic. Drives to the right. You're anticipating that right-handed hook shot.
By the Jazz, as here's Jared Allen. Back it goes to LeVert. Extra pass to Strus. Strus roars out of the corner. How about that bounce pass as he finds Evan Mobley?
Just chipping away at the interior paint of the Utah. Nice play here. Good little bounce pass, drop pass by Max Strus.
Evan Merrill and Niang make up the Cavalier five. Garland finds Allen. Allen makes a good catch, plays it off to Merrill, and Merrill makes no mistake.
Boy, that's give Jared Allen a lot of credit.
Merrill hit eight threes against the Jazz in Cleveland in December. Here's number five tonight.
Yeah, absolute bullet of a pass from Darius Garland to Jared Niang, using his body and strength.
Merrill inside to Morris. Morris shovels to Mobley. Mobley lays it up, and Mobley follows with a dunk.
Just dominant basketball by the Cavaliers.
Great. Mobley with the follow, and the Cavaliers on an 18-point lead. Here's LeVert from the Utah logo. Mobley works in toward Horton Tucker. He'll find Morris. Morris for three. Boy, good east-west ball movement. Horton Tucker skips one off to Sensabaugh.
Excellent defense.
Almost walked and he threw it away.
Yeah, excellent defense by Max Strus. He came over to help from weak side and fired out real fast to Sensabaugh so he can get a good shot up.
That you were talking about.
Yeah, he ends up stealing the basketball, but it's all started by him going weak side to help with Jarrett. And then he charged back out. And
meanwhile, for Doc Rivers, his Milwaukee Bucks will deploy Patrick Beverley in that starting lineup for Damian Lillard. Chris Middleton, Giannis Antetokounmpo, Brook Lopez, and Malik Beasley.
You commit two to three bodies of Giannis, you're going to be dead to rights.
Nice slice cut there by Corey Kispert off the feed from Jordan Poole. Played his college ball at the University of Wisconsin. Here's Denny. Nice cut. Good assist there by Jordan Poole. Denny, free and clear for a layup.
I mean, this is the time to eat at the basket. No Brook Lopez, no Giannis. That means no shot blocking ability for the Milwaukee Bucks. Take advantage.
Gallinari trying to use his dribble bag, but there's Jared Butler in there fighting for the ball. Wizards with possession. Good pass by Davis to Denny. Nice contest there by Tristan, who's running the floor. Wise decision to pass to Kispert. Kispert with a Euro step. Bucket there by Corey Kispert.
Right now, the Wizards with a 5-point lead.
Kispert comes back and goes off glass. He is right trying to show and go. Pass out to Kispert.
Yeah, that's what Jordan Poole is going to have to do.
Well, 2-for-1 action here for the Bucks. Blocked by Denny. Denny passes it out. Kispert, three, coming. Wizards with a 4-point lead to start the third. Chris Miller, Drew Gooden, Megan McPeak. Washington with the possession to start the third. Good ball movement. Oh. Inside to Denny. Rocking the rim on Giannis. Rebound there by Gill. Here's Kispert. Can he stay hot? Yes. Doc Rivers is not happy.
Because he knows.
17 for Middleton, 16 for Antetokounmpo. No one else on Milwaukee's team has scored double figures. Denny, count it, and the bucket.
Denny had Middleton set up.
Denny, crossover layup, very nice.
Let's get Denny Avdija at the top of the key.
Bucks now with 23 assists on 28 made field goals.
Right there, Denny Avdija.
Look at Kispert beat the pack down. Jordan Poole playing the role of quarterback.
And that's after a made basket, Chris.
A little more than two to go. Amarui, good pass inside. Good cut by Kispert. Poole over in the corner to the aforementioned Avdija. Great decision finding Kispert all net.
And that's been the name of the game, Chris, offensively.